get ahead of it.
Carly Fiorina's been added to the list of GOP candidates who will debate in primetime Wednesday evening, and Donald Trump's okay with that.
I ask that she be on the debate because I think she should. I think 11 people is far too many, but that'll start weeding out.
The CNN debate from the Reagan Library in Simi, California, will also be broadcast nationally on radio via the Salem Radio Network. Meanwhile, former Texas Governor Rick Perry Friday withdrew from the race, saying the remaining field is pretty stout.
Probably the greatest group of men and women.
Meanwhile, Perry said he had no regrets pulling out of the campaign 3 months after getting into it. And speaking of Donald Trump, in his event in Dallas, Monday is a sellout, but some ticket holders are putting their ducats up for bid on eBay, fetching as much as $200. A 24-year-old mother's in custody after her dirty, barefoot 4- and 6-year-old children were found living in a wooden shipping crate in an underground cave in Kansas City, Missouri. The woman's been charged with felony child endangerment. Police found the children while they were trying to serve a warrant on stolen vehicle. More on these stories at townhall.com.
You're on vacation when you feel it pop. Your tooth just broke. You're 1,000 miles from your regular dentist, so this is going to cost a small fortune. But not if you have the Dental and Vision Plus plan from MyDiscountHealth.com. Get discounts of 5 to 60% at participating providers all over the U.S. With MyDiscountHealth.com, save on routine exams, cleanings, even major work like dentures and root canals. The plan at MyDiscountHealth.com comes with discounts on prescription drugs, eyeglasses, and more, all for only $13 per month. Medicare doesn't cover dental work, so this is perfect for you. Learn more. Call 844-450-2273. That's 844-450-2273. This plan is not insurance. Members pay participating providers and receive discounts immediately. Savings will vary by provider and service. Cancel within 30 days to get a full refund less processing fee. Discount Medical Plan Organization is Carrington International Corp., Frisco, Texas. This plan is not available in all areas. Call 844-450-2273 or go to MyDiscountHealth.com.
U.S. regulators have filed civil fraud charges against a former federal prosecutor and Kentucky lieutenant governor.
The Securities and Exchange Commission accuses Stephen Pence of acting as a frontman for a convicted felon who schemed to divert $2.3 million from General Employment Enterprises. At the time, Pence was majority shareholder and chairman of the employment staffing company. Pence's attorney, Michael Valenti, says his client, quote, had nothing to do with that and had no knowledge of the missing funds. Valenti adds Pence will contest the charges.
Correspondent Jeremy House. Students and parents have a new tool today to help them sort out and sort through a maze of data as they make college choices. The redesigned online tool at the Education Department's website is designed to give students and their parents information about costs, student loans, and other data in order to make their collegiate decisions. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra. Georgia authorities are investigating the attack of a junior varsity football player by several teammates inside a locker room and reportedly while coaches looked on.
The teammates kicked the player, threw him headfirst into a trash can, and rolled the can down the hallway at Camden County High School. The report said Monday's attack happened after football practice and that a portion of it was captured on video and posted on Snapchat. According to the police report, teammates had attacked the player after he sat on the opposing team sideline during a Camden County Glenn Academy varsity game on September the 4th and wore the opposing team's color in support of his girlfriend, who is a Glenn Academy cheerleader. Patrick Voss reporting.
The longest-serving director of Ohio State University's marching band has died. Jonathan Wood spent 28 years directing the band until his retirement in 2012. Among his innovations, using computers to chart band formations in the 80s. He was 76. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Before using Heart and Body Extract, my energy level was very, very low. I could only walk a few feet and then would have to sit down. I was tired and lethargic. But after taking Heart and Body Extract, my energy level has improved greatly and I can now walk longer distances without getting tired so fast. Thank you, Heart and Body Extract.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
Free Talk Live.
Yes, it is yet another Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. We're here and we'll take your calls about anything you want to discuss with you in the studio tonight. You've got Ian.
And Mark.
And usually a good sign that we should talk about something, because we always bring something to the table to talk to you about, is that when you and I, Mark, we do our show prep separately. You are at your house, I'm at mine, and we kind of compare notes when you come in here, and we have the same story tonight.
We do.
Which is about an unwanted kiss. But first I want to welcome Jared County's original hometown station, or Garrett County, excuse me. Garrett is the proper pronunciation. Garrett County in Lancaster, Kentucky, WZXI 1280. Welcome aboard. They are a brand new Saturday night affiliate, and a station been off the air for a few years, and this guy's been pouring his life savings and getting it back on the air, so happy to be on board.
It's really radio is a labor of love.
Yeah, so welcome aboard. As we introduce you to this new program, for those of you in Lancaster, you've never heard a show probably like this before. It's open phone.
There isn't a show like this.
Which is pretty, that's not particularly unusual. But we're also pro-liberty, which means we're not one of those Republican or Democrat talking point shows that you might hear so commonly on talk radio. So if you want to test us out, you're certainly welcome to join us here. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. But in the news, from Inquisitor.com, 13-year-old Pikesville, Maryland boy is being charged with second-degree assault for kissing a 14-year-old girl on a dare. Police were called to the scene after the alleged assault occurred on Friday at Pikesville Middle School, where officials told the Maryland police that a 13-year-old boy had kissed the 14-year-old during school hours. The high school officials also stated the kiss was unwanted by said female student.
One gets that impression.
And was given based on a dare made by friends of the boy. He'll be charged as a juvenile in the second-degree assault charge case, and police said no one was injured in the kissing incident.
I gotta wonder who thinks that this is an appropriate punishment. It seems like this is a pretty commonplace kind of thing that goes on, except for the arrest part. Right? I mean, I don't recall in my childhood, and I don't think 13 is exactly a child, but it's moving into adulthood, young adulthood.
Mm-hmm.
I don't recall ever having had an incident like this, but I've had people kiss me without my permission before.
I was kissed when I was in preschool. I specifically remember a couple of the girls there would go around kissing some of the boys,
yep.
And it was unwanted at that time. They even had a name. They were the Kissy Kissy Girls. And
I think in the preschool and 13 might be a bit of a chasm there as far as...
Is there? I mean, we're just talking about the same act here,
true.
Right? I mean, it's ridiculous to say that this is in any way some sort of criminal matter.
Yeah, right? it's ridiculous for it to be a criminal matter.
It's ridiculous at age 13.
It happened at school.
It's ridiculous at age 3.
It happened at school. School should be handling it as a disciplinary matter in the way that schools have handled things just like this as disciplinary matters for many, many, many years.
Up
and if
until
the school can't handle it, the school should shut down.
Yeah.
School officials? How can they call themselves officials?
Yeah, they're just cop callers at this point. They're letting the police handle their disciplinary issues, and this has been more of a common thing. Now, it's the first time we've heard this particular example of this, but it's not as uncommon these days to have the police called on students for doing just sort of normal kid stuff at school. I remember we were reading an article about Texas where they are just handing out, I think it was Class D or Class C misdemeanors, one of the lowest classifications of misdemeanors to high school students and even middle and elementary school students on a regular basis in Texas.
In Mississippi, we saw charges of vandalism for writing on desks or carving into desks and that sort of thing. I mean, that happened all the time.
So, I mean, it's crazy and it's not uncommon. And, of course, it's yet another reason to keep your kids out of the government school. If you want to prevent these kind of insane criminal charges from happening, then make sure your kids aren't going to government schools and try to come up with something else that they can do, like going to a private school or unschooling or homeschooling. But it does make me wonder if there's anyone in the audience tonight who actually feels like, yes, the police needed to be called in about this. This is unwanted sexual behavior.
Somebody's going to have to explain it to me in some way that I haven't yet understood it for me to get it, why you could possibly support the police being called here.
Maybe you think that this boy needs to be taught a lesson and that all these other boys need to pay attention so they don't be going around doing this anymore. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Now, I don't want to make it sound like this isn't a matter that should be taken seriously. It's not okay to go around and, you know, it would not be okay to go and kiss somebody who does not want it. It's not okay to whip your penis out and, you know, hit the person with that, right? Like, even though it doesn't do any damage, it's still an unwanted assault.
I mean, it's unacceptable.
Get that, right? I get that. But, you know, coming up with some sort of solution within the school certainly seems to be the, you know, go pick up some garbage at lunchtime or something like that.
An apology might be a place to start, too. You know, look, I just thought it was a good idea, and now, you know, in retrospect, it didn't seem like it's such a good idea.
Coerced apologies, though, I don't think are really worth anything.
No, but I think that there's I think there's a time and a place for them. They may not be worth anything for the student, but they might be worth something for the victim.
Yeah, but if it's not a real apology, then what is the point?
To make the person who was assaulted feel better?
Does it make you feel better if you don't think the person's sincere?
Yeah, that's it. You know, it's a good opportunity for everybody to work on their acting skills.
Well, I don't appreciate that. I mean, if somebody's not really sincerely interested in apologizing, I don't think that they should be coerced into it. I think that takes all the value out of it.
The adult world is full of interactions that are not entirely voluntary and not entirely authentic. So, yeah, I don't have a problem with it.
855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. You can join us here, 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well, and you're welcome to join us at that by calling us up at username lrn.fm. Let's go to Chris, listening to WIBC in Indianapolis. Hello, Chris. You're on Free Talk.
Hi, how are you guys?
Hey, good. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, to some extent, I do kind of agree with the punishment for the...
Well, we don't know what the punishment is yet. He's been charged with criminal assault.
Having the cops called, now maybe the charge may be a little too much, but having the cops called to maybe scare him would have been, you know, something that...
But that's what the cops do. You understand that, right? When you call the police, they're likely going to charge someone with something. That's kind of their bailiwick. Well, that's their gig.
It's the same way as if, you know, I was a 13-year-old boy and... say I went around kicking a dog or a cat, that's criminal, or that's, you know, hang on just a second.
Yes, daddy's on the radio.
Abusing an animal. So I guess that could lead up to something more when they're adults.
So well, it could. I mean, any singular disciplinary action could result in things when they get older. That's why we have these retrospectives on serial killers that are so interesting on some of these, like the History Channel and these sorts of things. But the fact is that many of the things that you'll see, say, serial killers on the History Channel do when they're young, a lot of people who do not turn out to be serial killers on the History Channel also did when they were young. So I don't know that... I can agree with your logic. Another thing that concerns me is as many times...
But why take the chance?
What's that?
Why take the chance?
You take a chance when you call the cops. Have you seen some of the stories where cops go in and taser five-year-olds or go in people's houses and shoot their dogs?
Well, I mean, now that's wrong, of course.
Why take the chance?
The scare him. I mean, maybe a probation.
Why do you need to scare him? I mean, he's not a serial
kisser. Principal didn't scare you, dude?
Well, I mean, you know... If it was unwanted, that is kind of a sexual assault. Granted, he's young, but he's being charged as a juvenile. I feel that it's a fair punishment, especially if it is unwanted.
You don't know what the punishment is yet. He hasn't been sentenced.
Well, I mean, just a light punishment. I mean, if he is charged with something.
You consider calling the police for this to be a light punishment?
Well, if I went up and kissed a girl out on the street that didn't want it, I mean, she would call the police on me.
Maybe.
I mean, that could very well happen.
And yeah, but shouldn't a kid get a break? I mean, shouldn't a kid, somebody who's very young, get the opportunity to not have the police
still learning social norms?
Yeah, exactly. Hey, Chris, thanks for your call and thoughts, man. It's Free Talk Live. Share yours.
The following is an important free offer for smokers only. The makers of O2Pure, the world's most advanced e-cigarette, have just authorized the release of free starter kits to all smokers who call in the next 10 minutes. Valued at $99, these starter kits are available for free, but only while supplies last. To guarantee your free kit, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-717-9859. The revolutionary O2Pure design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no nasty tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love whenever and wherever they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with O2Pure. Again, free starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24-7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Attention, all men. Are you urinating more frequently? Do you wake up to urinate? Are you having a slower, weaker stream? Don't ignore the warning signs of your aging prostate. Get your free bottle of Super Beta Prostate. Super Beta Prostate is guaranteed to support a more complete emptying of your bladder, a fuller, stronger stream, and less waking at night to urinate.
Super Beta Prostate is a product that I really like. I endorse it. I use it myself. I was very pleasantly surprised that Super Beta Prostate helped me fairly quickly.
Super Beta Prostate is formulated with a natural plant enzyme called beta-sitosterol. It's so powerful, you'd have to take 100 salt palmetto pills to get the same sterols as just one Super Beta Prostate tablet. Don't ignore the warning signs of your aging prostate. Call now to get your free bottle of Super Beta Prostate. Call 1-800-853-1203. That's 1-800-853-1203. 800-853-1203.
Do you owe the IRS money? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. There is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call now for your free and confidential analysis. 800-481-3147. Again, that's 800-481-3147. 800-481-3147.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Well, this one might be a first. A 13-year-old male has kissed a 14-year-old female at his school in Maryland. It's Pikesville Middle School, and now is being charged as a juvenile with a second-degree assault charge. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
You can join us here with your thoughts. Our last caller actually said that he thought this was a light punishment to call the police and allow the police to handle it. Just like, you know, you don't know what they're going to do when you call them, and you don't get to control it at that point. So if you want to join us here, we've also got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm.
Hopefully there won't be any unauthorized kissing going on at the Bitcoin Investor Conference in Las Vegas, where I'm going. That's
what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas.
So I imagine that doesn't just stay in Vegas. That's just my guess there. October the 29th and 30th, so coming up soon. Still, they have early bird tickets available, though. You go to bitcoininvestor.com. There's going to be lots of speakers, including Trace Mayer. Dr. Stephanie Murphy is going to be there. Of course, I am. Lots of Bitcoin enthusiasts. It's happening at the beautiful D Hotel, which accepts Bitcoin. So for those of you who are interested, it is going to be a great event, and you don't want to miss it. Bitcoininvestor.com. We're going to be doing the Free Talk Live from there, so come on out and check us out. Bitcoininvestor.com.
Let's go to the phones and the fun. We've got Steve listening in Illinois to WRMN. Hey, Steve.
Hey, how you doing today?
What's on your mind? Go ahead.
Now, let me get this straight. There's a 13-year-old boy and a 14-year-old girl?
That's correct.
The boy kissed the girl.
Yeah, that's right. It was a dare, allegedly, and the kiss was just a brief kiss. It's not clear whether it was on the cheek or the lips. That's not made clear here in the story. But either way, they're charging him with assault.
Oh, God. Get a hold of the FBI.
Yeah. This kid needs hard labor.
The girl's going to be traumatized for life. She's going to have to go through counseling, don't you know? I mean, this is a never-ending thing. No, actually, I just wanted to call my, my sister and my nephew. When he was 9, he kissed a Chaldean girl on the cheek. I don't know where Chaldeans are from, but they're of the Muslim faith, and that's very, very repulsed to that religion. And they were friends, but after that, the family picked up and moved.
Wow.
It was so offensive to them. Oh, yeah. Yeah. So, there's a little blown out of proportion. Like you said, the official shouldn't be officiating. Just get them out of there.
So you agree that police being called is entirely inappropriate for this?
Inappropriate, uncalled for, unnecessary, and a waste of taxpayers' time and money.
No doubt.
Criminals, real ones, to get rid of. Not a 13-year-old boy going through his pubescent ages and just checking it out.
Yeah, it seems like the principal probably could have handled this. I can assure you the principals at the schools that I, or the vice principal, depending on the school I was at, mm-hmm. would have handled this and handled it, you know, just fine. I don't see any particular reason for this. Also, I think there might be something to be said for if you make a big deal about this, it may very well be
more traumatic
yeah. for everyone involved.
I think that's absolutely true. Steve, thanks for your call and sharing your thoughts tonight. Our toll-free number for you to join us is 855-450-FREE. I mean, honestly, does it have to be traumatic? I understand that people could make it out that way, like, my God, you've been sexually assaulted. Or you could look at it a different way. You could look at it as, that's kind of a compliment. I mean, it's a rude way to compliment somebody. It's not appropriate to touch somebody in an unwanted manner. But it's not, you know, an offensive thing. It's a kiss. That's generally a thing that is positive between human beings.
Well, an unwanted kiss is not going to be that great of a thing. I'm just trying to imagine what it would be like if I was just wandering down the street and somebody decided to plant an unwanted kiss on my mouth. And, you know, I'd be like, all right, well, that could have been avoided. That would have been better if that didn't happen. But I mean, I just don't think that it would have been.
You just move on.
Right.
Move on with your day.
I just can't see me getting all bent out of shape. And I'm not imagining a woman kissing me in the lips. I'm trying to imagine some guy kissing me in the lips because that would be the most unwanted, right? And I happen to imagine a beard because that would be even more unwanted for me.
Prickly. Yeah.
So even so, I'm just like, I can't put myself in the realm where I'm thinking that, you know what, this person needs a good little bit of incarceration. That's going to fix them.
Well, yeah, of course, we've yet to see what will actually happen as a result of this. I mean, whether they're going to put him in juvie.
Didn't he get booked? I mean, we're still talking about incarceration here. If you're being taken to the jail, if you're charged with something, he's taken to the jail, he's fingerprinted, he's held in some level of confinement for some period of time before he is released to his parental units who then take care of it. I don't know. It's all so crazy to me.
It's possible he was arrested. It's not made clear.
He was arrested.
Was he charged. Just because you're charged doesn't mean that you've been taken into the station. They could have written out a ticket and handed it to him.
Isn't it second degree assault?
They do, yeah.
I don't know. It doesn't sound like a ticket to me.
You're right. I mean, knowing it's probably a safe presumption to presume that he was taken in to the police station and booked. But we don't have that information, and there's a chance that he wasn't.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying.
And for those that are thinking to themselves, well, he's probably never going to do it again, could we not have had another scenario here where he didn't do it again? I mean, is it possible that you don't have to turn up the volume to 11?
On the first offense.
At this point, we have no evidence that he is somehow going around kissing people and saying that it's...
not a serial
kisser. Just keep
kisser.
On daring me. I can't stop myself. I'm a dare maniac. Right? Like, we don't have any evidence that that's the case here.
Right. I mean, look, the typical response would usually just happen in the moment, right? Where a girl might slap you. For something like that.
And frankly,
and you deserve it.
I don't advocate for that kind of response. However, I will not, that's...
It's a legitimate response. It's a legitimate response to defend yourself.
It's a likely result that I would not make anyone apologize for.
Right. Let's talk to Straight Razor. He's in Texas, listening via the TuneIn app. Hello, Straight Razor.
Hey, what's going on?
Welcome.
I'm just wondering if the English teachers had enough time to write up a request for a new grant to build camps for these children.
Camps? Because, what kind of camps?
Yeah, like FEMA camps, because obviously they need to go away forever. I mean, it's just so atrocious that we need to spend gobs and gobs of government money on it, don't you know?
Well, the government money is going to be spent already. The schools are the built and the cops are employed, so...
Send them to a re-education camp?
Exactly. That's what the English teachers should have been working on while the police were on their way.
Now, Straight Razor, so, I mean, but more seriously, you are a former law enforcement officer down there in Texas. Were you seeing any of this going on? Because we've read a story in the past. It's been a few years, but a story about Texas just charging people, different towns in Texas just charging teenagers and even elementary schoolers with Class C, I believe it was, misdemeanors there.
Well, it's going to depend on where you are. So I didn't have a large school or even really a substantial school in my area. But you also have to consider that you have the whole Jesus thing down here. So depending on where you are and how religious that area is, then you may have a different response from the individuals there.
Straight Razor, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. It's Free Talk Live.
Global warming covertly describes the effects of iron poisoning. CO2 is iron poison blood types and is the body's defense mechanism to buffer the oxygen iron attracts. CO2 in blood and blood type prevalences are used as false evidence for global warming and is the setup for the greatest fraud in history. The healthy blood type AB is on the Shroud of Turin and is their DNA proof they are his Christ. For further information, unveilingthem.com, UNVEILINGthem.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Mike Stenerson from Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it, so decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. It is the live Saturday edition of the program, and you're invited to join us here. The toll-free number for you, 855-450-FREE. You can also join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. The toll-free number again, 855-450-FREE. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And if you care about privacy when you're on the internet, you need ProXPN. It is a virtual private network, and they encrypt your online data so your internet service provider will no longer know what you're doing with their own internet connection. And that's a good thing because that means they can't sell it to other companies and they can't, you know, data mine about you and they can't turn it over to the government either. So you can get started over at proxpn.com. Use code FTL50. You'll get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy the annual account with that code FTL50. And by the way, ProXPN does it right. They offer OpenVPN, which is the gold standard of network encryption. They've got apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and there's even Linux support as well. So whatever your operating system, whatever your device, you can go and get ProXPN right now at proxpn.com. Use code FTL50 and take back the privacy that is your right. As we go to the phones to your calls and thoughts, a 13-year-old male is in hot water in Pikesville, Maryland, for kissing a 14-year-old girl on a dare while at school. School officials called the police rather than just dealing with it there at the school, as would have been done when pretty much all of us listening to the show were in school.
Right, because I think this is a first, so.
It seems like it, but maybe you know of some sort of other awful story you want to tell us. You're welcome to do that here. 855-450-FREE. Let's talk to Ellen. She's listening to WIBC in Indianapolis. Hey, Ellen.
Hey, I listen to you guys every time that I'm coming up through here. It seems like you guys are on. I just love you.
Cool, thanks.
I drive this way frequently.
Are you a truck driver?
I grew up, yes.
Okay.
I grew up in Maryland. Yeah, I've got you on my, I've got your program set on my radio.
Real quick, I want to say thanks for your service because folks just don't know everything they've got, they get because somebody, decided to dedicate their life to your profession and bringing things to us. So I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Oh, well, thank you, because you're right. A lot of people don't know, and this is a lot like work.
it's a lot like that.
This would be fun, just driving down the road. No, this is a lot like work.
Yeah, all right, so you got to watch out for everybody else.
So what were you calling about tonight? Go ahead, Ellen.
This 13-year-old kid. I grew up in Maryland. But this 13-year-old kid, here we have a government that has put in all these new standards of teaching and all this programming into our school, and we're not allowed to be offended by the stuff that our kids are coming home and talking to us about, but yet some minor little thing like this happens and they call the police. It is just more of the war that is going on here against, people in this country.
I wonder what the girl's opinion was about this, right? Because this could have been something where she didn't even go to the teachers or whatever. It could have been witnessed by some bureaucrat, and they could have just taken action even without her wanting them to. I mean, what would you have done? Let's say you were the 14-year-old girl and some, ugly kid came up and kissed you.
Well, I've had, that kind of thing happens in school all the time.
Sure.
I mean, I've had it happen to me in school.
I can't imagine this isn't just womanhood.
That had a crush on me that came up and kissed me in high school.
What did you do?
This is just normal. Well, I was kind of embarrassed about it, but the guy became friends. I mean, we became friends. His name's George. I still remember him. I haven't seen him for years, but, why make this a big deal? And it's all this, politically correctness, and you're going to start acting in a specific way. And it's so un-American that somebody is telling us how to act.
Thank you, Ellen, for your call tonight. Drive safe out there. Appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. That's cool that it happened to her and she became friends with the guy.
Yeah, I think that to some extent adulthood is about dealing with unwanted advances, right? Like that's something we can't keep. That's something you're going to learn in life, that the fact is that there's going to be unwanted advances. Now, this advance went even further than it should have, right? Mm-hmm. Like it went to physical before we had some conversation about, I'm just not interested, whatever that might be. But, this is an opportunity for everybody to learn kind of how to deal with these situations. And that's what school's supposed to be about. It's supposed to be about learning.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. And, in this case, with this young lady, it does make me curious as to how he pulled this off. I mean, because if there's a guy coming up to you, and he keeps coming, he's going to get into your personal space real fast. I mean, it would be even harder to kiss a girl on the lips than it would on the cheek, right? Like, you could sneak up, I think, probably from the side, perhaps, and successfully give somebody a peck on the cheek without them being able to react too quickly. But coming up from the front of somebody,
I don't like to speculate because you just don't know how these things.
Well, we don't know. But I mean, look,
down.
It's going to be harder to kiss somebody on the lips than it is on the cheek.
He could have gone with the I'm going to give you a hug thing. And I think there's a lot of pressure on people to administer hugs and receive them. I'm not saying I'm not for hugs. I am for hugs. But, ultimately, I think that it's kind of like we're so pro-hug in this society that people don't have a chance to really say, hey, you know what? I'm just not hugging today. Thanks.
Justin's on the line in Indiana. Justin, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
I just have a problem with the charge on this 13-year-old boy. Sorry, it just kind of peeved me that they're talking about assault.
Do you think there should be a different charge, or the police should not have been called at all, or what?
I don't believe the police should have been called at all. All this talk from all these people about government stepping in where they shouldn't be, yet the first time that something isn't perfect for somebody, they call in the government, whether it be the police, social services, or any division of it.
Well, in this case, the government was there already because it was a government school.
Yeah. Can't get away from the government there.
Yeah. But there's certain things that should be handled with at home, and especially with children, that as adults we should take care of that as our by ourselves. Respectfully, if the parents had to be involved, I could understand the school saying, hey, let's call your parents in. Let's call your parents in. Because you're taking away a child's right to learn how adults should respond.
Thank you, Justin. I appreciate it. Thanks for the call tonight, man. Let's talk to Dan in Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. Go ahead.
Thank you for taking my call. I was listening to your show and just saying the whole thing, yeah, why don't you move on to something else? And then my 15-year-old daughter walked into the room. And now, keep in mind, she's the fourth daughter that I've raised, and I've also raised three boys. And she said, oh, yeah, that boy is harassing her sexually. And I don't know what they did, but they needed to make it strong. Because what happens is these boys grow up and they don't have any respect for women. They think this stuff is funny. And then in college, they rape the girls.
Well, now, it's a long way to go to say that somebody who kisses a girl on a dare is going to turn into a rapist. And I'm not sure that calling the police is going to dissuade that person more so than internal school punishment.
I will say that 20 years ago, you would have got an older brother to go in and kick the boy's tail. But nowadays, you can't do that because if the boys fight, the police are called. So there is no option.
I'm glad those days are gone if that's true, because I don't think violence is going to make this better. But you actually are calling in the cops. If you want to hang on, Dan, I'd like you to talk a little bit more about that. Dan in Virginia is with us here. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE, and he says it was an appropriate response to call in the police for an unwanted kiss, because he could turn into a rapist. We need to have the police come and scare him. 855-450-FREE. What do you think? It's Free Talk Live.
Did you know that in today's market, home loan payments are often less than rent payments? This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute, with a few more good reasons to buy a home. First, interest rates are near historic lows. This places the real cost of purchasing a home near a 50-year low. That's not even taking into account the possible tax benefits. Second, buying builds equity. On most mortgage loans, you're paying down the principal balance with each payment. And over the last 50 years, increasing home values have typically outpaced inflation. And let's face it, home ownership isn't just about the money. It's about living the American dream, where your family is part of a community. While you own a home, you have the freedom to customize. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com. That's VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
So I found out the other day that at guns80.com, a lot of people don't get the Ghost AR-15 rifle kits because they're afraid that they won't be able to do the machining work required to drill out and make ready the lower. Well, listen, guys, gals, I am not that good of a machinist, I promise you. But I was able to take a drill press with an XY table and knock this out in about 45 minutes, and in all honesty, mine looks really good. Go get yours. Don't be afraid. It's easy. Guns80.com. Go to guns80.com now.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be the Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us. Toll-free, 855-450-FREE. People are sharing their thoughts with us here tonight on the 13-year-old young man who kissed a girl, a 14-year-old young lady at the middle school that they attend. And he did it in an unwanted manner. It was a challenge, ostensibly a dare from his friends. And he's now being charged with second-degree assault as a juvenile. And we actually found somebody who believes that that is A-OK. And I want to continue with your calls and thoughts here in a moment. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Dan listening in Virginia. Back to Dan, rather. Dan, you called in. You said that you were thinking about your teenage daughter, and you thought that, you know, back in the day, you'd have called in a brother to kick the butt of the person who kissed the young lady, but today that's not possible. And so you think it's totally okay to call the police in because he might turn into a rapist. Is that I don't want to put words in your mouth, but is that pretty much what you'd said before?
No, that's not what I said. Okay. What I said was I was hoping that you would just move on to another topic. And then my 15-year-old daughter walked into the room and she said, "You don't." And again, I said, I've raised daughters over the last 30 years. I've raised them and I've seen the times change where the boys don't fight anymore. And I'd like to take you on that point also about boys not fighting. I think that's a lot of the reason that we're having this gun violence with the boys is because they're not fighting and they don't know how to, they just don't know how to get it out of their system. Now, as far as my daughter coming into the room, she said,
what is the gun violence? Before you go on with your daughter, what are you saying? There's more gun violence now? In fact, violent crime is lower than it's ever been. Isn't that true?
Not in the school system, it's not.
Oh, you're talking about shootings?
Not these mass shootings. Yeah, I'm talking about
school shootings,
right?
Like the mass shootings kind of things?
Yeah, we're not allowing the boys to grow up and learn how to fight.
I'm pretty sure that Dylan Klebold and, what was it, Eric Harris?
No, those
from
boys were wacko. They're wacko, okay?
Oh, they're wacko, but the rest of them are just, you know, they're deprived of fighting? I mean, this is the most ridiculous theory I've ever heard. The idea that if only boys would fight more in school, that would somehow reduce violence?
I bet you're not going to find I'm the only one that thinks that.
Oh, I'm sure there's a bunch of lunatics out there. But, you know, just because a few people believe something, or even if a lot of people believe something, doesn't mean it's true. That's a logical fallacy, sir. Argumentum ad populum, as they call it.
Well, let's put that one to rest. I want to talk about the assault charge here on this young lady. Now, you've got five daughters and four sons?
I've raised four daughters. Four daughters.
Four daughters and five sons?
No, four daughters and three sons.
And three sons. Excellent.
Now, the 15... Right.
Would one of your three sons have been better off if they had been charged for doing something like this? I mean, we're talking about these are criminal charges levied by, the executive branch of the government. Would your sons have been – surely they did something sort of, you know, cute, as it were, in these circumstances. Surely they did something that would have been – that could have been a charge. I know I did in school. So would they have been better off?
No, you're lucky that a big brother didn't come after you.
My butt kicked in school. There's no doubt about it. I'm not saying that I'm better off or worse off as a result. I'm not making that claim. I'm asking you specifically: would your sons have been better off with a criminal charge if they had done something that was, you know, chargeable? The fact that there are, you know, so many charges out there is kind of the problem in the first place.
Okay, well, can I answer you on two different ways?
Please.
I'd like to answer the first way. Yes, because again, there's no other defense today. No, because I believe that the police are spending too much time building up charges on people so that they can get them into prison. Now, my daughter's answer was, I don't care what the authorities would have said. I would have punched the guy in the face, okay?
And I think that she would be justified.
You think that she would have or not?
I do.
Yeah, she would have punched him in the face. Okay, but again, we're living in a different time now, unfortunately, in which things are set up. So the only choice you have, she was telling me about one of her friends that's just getting repeatedly texted, very disrespectfully, from one of her classmates in her very classroom. And she said, told her to tell the guy to leave him alone. And so then he starts, what's wrong with me? What's wrong with me? They've got the phones. They got everything now. And they said the level of disrespect towards the girls is a whole new level that we didn't grow up with. And the difference is that today the girls are learning to not put up with it. And I'm proud of my daughter for that.
So why do you need to bring the police in then?
Because apparently the girl is afraid to punch him in the face.
Well,
and there wasn't a big brother to go whip his tail.
So I'm thinking technology, since they're getting texted in this circumstance.
Oh, he's gone.
He dropped off. Oh, well, I didn't drop him. Since the young woman in his circumstance is getting texted, that there might be a technological solution to this problem,
Blocking.
Right. Just block the phone number, and then you don't have to worry about somebody who's doesn't understand boundaries and these sorts of things. Look, I'm a nationally syndicated radio talk show host. Crazy people, and I'm also the sales executive for this show.
Mm-hmm.
So I both sell ads, which means that I have to have my telephone number out there so people can get it, and I'm the host, which means that I probably shouldn't have my telephone number out there. You get it? That means I've got a telephone number that I can type in. Yep, this number called me. Yep, that's a crazy person. Tick, tick. And they can't call me anymore. So I would say that that's the way to go. Now, I've got this number for free from Google. It's a Google Voice number.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps this is a solution that might work for some young lady who's getting a bunch of texts from somebody who she doesn't want texts from.
There's apparently even a way to do it with your regular phone now. I wouldn't doubt it, but I don't know how you do it, but I've heard that with Android, I think that's possible. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So what you're pointing out there is, even though technology has made it easier to send unwanted messages to people, it also has made it easier to block those people.
Right. When people talk about cyberbullying, look, there are plenty of people that would love to share their opinion with me, and much of their opinion has to do with my opinion being crappy. And they would love to monopolize the other 21 hours out of the day that I do not do a nationally syndicated talk show. So I've had to learn how to deal with folks like this. You don't have to. It's not cyberbullying. It's just people that don't understand boundaries.
Let's go to Elaine, listening in Indiana. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Elaine.
Hello.
Hey, you're on the air.
Okay, good. I'm sad for that little boy that they called the police,
because his parents could have contacted her parents and they could have got everything worked out.
Absolutely.
And if it was an unwanted kiss and she didn't like it at all, then he needs to apologize to her. But to call the police and give that boy a criminal record at such a young age, that's horrible. That's just horrible.
Now, odds are good that he's going to have his record expunged, you know, as time goes on, because he is 13 and it is a juvenile charge. But all that said, it's
horrible.
If he
gets another charge in the next 5 years, though, that charge will be, you know, sort of counted against him.
Well, and it is also just horrible to expose someone who hasn't actually really harmed anyone to the criminal justice system unnecessarily. I mean, that's the real horror of this, is that now he's going to have to go to – he might have had to go into the police station to be booked. He might have been, you know, thrown in the back of a police car. He might have been, you know, manhandled by the police, may have been ultimately sentenced to some sort of juvenile sentence. Going to court is a real stressful situation. All of this over a little kiss, and that is incredibly unjust.
It's horrible. It is horrible.
Thanks, Elaine.
Absolutely horrible.
Anything else you want to share with us?
Well, my son, when he was 8 years old, had a little girl that was continuously kicking him in the privates when they were out playing. And they lived in the same apartment complex we did. And he was always taught not to hit girls. So I went and talked to the mother, and she was going through a divorce, and the daughter and another kid lived with her, and the other kid lived with dad, and this girl wasn't handling it well. And I explained to her that my son had never laid a hand on her, and she had repeatedly done this over a week's time. And my son was taught not to hit girls. And I explained to her, if she does this again, Tim has my permission to forget she is a girl.
Thanks, Elaine, for your call tonight.
That is wrong.
It is. It is wrong.
Said, you know, do you understand what she's saying here? She goes, yeah. And she looked at him and she apologized. And she was just as good as gold to him the rest of the time.
Point on.
She stayed with her mom.
Yeah, I agree with that. I feel like, you know, I don't think you should hit anyone in general. But if you need to defend yourself, it shouldn't matter if that person is a girl who's attacking you. I think that the rule that you shouldn't hit a girl, if a girl's attacking you just like a man is attacking you, you have the right to defend yourself.
I think is
exactly.
When we're talking about young people, so like males, boys and girls, they're very similar physiologically, sort of the upper body strength and that sort of thing. I think once a man hits a certain, you know, once you hit a certain age and a certain size, a certain musculature, then you have to kind of figure out ways to handle women that are being violent that might not include hitting.
Thanks for the call, Elaine. I appreciate it. Well, like I said, I don't think you should generally hit anybody, Mark. But
generally,
if somebody's attacking you, you have the right to defend yourself.
I'm
it doesn't matter what genitals they have between their legs.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose to nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
You're listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
News this hour, townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRoxter. There's a winner of the U.S. Open. 33-year-old Flavia Pennetta beat fellow Italian Roberta Vinci in straight sets to become the oldest first-time women's major champion in the Open era. Meanwhile, the former tennis star who was tackled during a mistaken arrest by a New York City police officer says the officer should lose his job.
I don't think this person should ever have a badge or a gun again. And I don't think it's too much to ask. He's had 5 civil complaints in 4 years, which is more than 90% of the police force has over their entire career.
James Blake says the mayor and the police commissioner have apologized to him, but he knows that's only because of who he is and how widely his story's been reported.
I'm sure this isn't the first time police brutality has happened, and I'm sure it's not the last time. So I want them to apologize to the people that this happens to that don't have the same voice that I have.
Officer James Frascatori, who's now on desk duty, has been named in several civil lawsuits. If you want one of the free tickets to Donald Trump's rally in Dallas Monday, be prepared to shell out about $200. That's the going rate on the internet. Wednesday evening debate from the Reagan Library will now include Trump along with newly added Carly Fiorina, as well as the main contenders, Jeb Bush, Ben Carson, Marco Rubio, Scott Walker, Ted Cruz, Mike Huckabee, Rand Hall, Chris Christie, and John Kasich. It'll be televised on CNN and broadcast nationally on radio via the Salem Radio Network. But one person that Trump won't have to worry about is Rick Perry.
I'm suspending my campaign for the presidency of the United States.
Perry made the announcement in St. Louis yesterday, 3 months after making his second attempt at the GOP nomination. And politics took a hard left in Britain Saturday after Jeremy Corbyn was elected leader of Britain's opposition Labour Party Saturday with 60% of the vote. The runaway victory now threatens to further divide the party after its heavy defeats in elections earlier this year. More on these stories at townhall.com.
America was built by people with a few dollars and a dream. And while many don't know it, there's one path to success that still only requires a dream and about $10. That's right. If your dream is to start or grow your business, something as simple as the right business card could make all the difference. And today, at Vistaprint.com, you can get 500 full-color business cards for only $9.99. That's right, 500 business cards for just $9.99. What's more, you can choose between hundreds of designs or upload your own and customize them easily. And because they're from Vistaprint.com, the cards are of top quality and your satisfaction is 100% guaranteed. So visit Vistaprint.com today and get 500 shots at turning your dream into reality. Hurry, because this offer won't last long. To get your 500 business cards for just $9.99, go to Vistaprint.com, click on the link in the upper right corner, and use promo code 2323. That's Vistaprint.com, click on the link in the upper right corner, and use promo code 2323.
There were apparently no terrorist activities in the U.S. Friday on the 14th anniversary of the 9/11 attacks, says Connie Lawn reports.
9/11 is one of the most horrific anniversaries in U.S. history. Over 3,000 died when they were attacked by 4 hijacked planes in 2001. Al-Qaeda was blamed for the attacks. This 14th anniversary passed with dignity, service to others, many tears and prayers. If there were terrorist plots, they were thwarted. The White House claims the U.S. is safer than it was 14 years ago. But experts warn terrorist attacks can happen any time and any place. Connie Lawn reporting from Washington.
The Army says a soldier who vanished during a parachuting training operation in Washington State Friday has been found dead. The soldier... unidentified at this point, was part of the Special Forces Unit based at Joint Base Lewis-McChord. News and analysis at townhall.com. A change in government procedures has led to a big jump in people losing coverage under the Obama health care law because of immigration and citizenship issues.
More than 400,000 had their insurance canceled, nearly 4 times as many as last year. The Obama administration says it is following the letter of the law, and this year that means a shorter time frame for resolving immigration and citizenship issues. But advocates say the administration's system for verifying eligibility is seriously flawed and consumers who are legally entitled to benefits are paying the price. Patrick Voss reporting.
A Russian space capsule has landed safely in Kazakhstan, bringing home a three-person crew from the International Space Station, including cosmonaut Gennady Padalka, who just completed his fifth mission for a world record 879 total days in space. More on these stories at townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
It's Free Talk Live.
Free Talk Live.
That's right. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. 13-year-old young man in trouble with the law after kissing a 14-year-old young lady on the lips at school.
We don't know if it's on the lips, but we think it is.
Oh, you're right. Thank you. Could have been on the lips, could have been cheek, but either way, he kissed her. She didn't like it. She didn't want it. We don't know if she was the one who went to the administration or if it was just witnessed by someone, some bureaucrat at the school. But either way, the police were called in. And I'm actually, you know, I'm pretty amazed that we did actually manage to dig up a couple of folks in the last hour who thought calling the police was an appropriate response to an unwanted kiss in middle school. And I just can't even see under any circumstance how that could be an appropriate response. Maybe if he'd come up and headbutted her or something like that, you know, then you could possibly justify it.
But everybody's walking away, you know, largely the way they came physically to the experience, as we understand it.
Maybe with a little icky feeling on one party's part, but that's about it. And so shouldn't the punishment, if any, have been within the school? Maybe make him go and pick up some garbage or, you know, give him some sort of internal school punishment. I don't think you should just have to go sit in a study hall or whatever, or internal detention. I always like the ones where you'd have to go and do something, you know, something productive. Just sitting in a room staring at a wall I don't think is an appropriate punishment. But what do you think? You're welcome to share your thoughts here with us tonight. Mark, I know you had something to add to the discussion, but let's go first to Renee, listening in Indianapolis. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Renee.
Hi, how are you guys tonight?
Hey, welcome. You're on the air. Good.
Thank you. I'm a police officer, have been for, 25 years now.
Well, that should be interesting. Good.
Indiana law for battery, which is same as assault, you have to have touched someone in a rude, insolent, or angry manner. And unless that boy touched her in one of those ways here, we would have never been called. Or if we were called, he wouldn't have been charged.
Well, this is rude.
Also, if he was... but was he? Did he have the intent of being rude? It was not a dare. To be funny.
Well,
it was a dare.
But didn't he think the rudeness was funny?
No, he could have. But, I mean, you have to prove it in court that he did it rudely.
Okay.
Was the malice there?
So you don't think this would have happened in Indy? You can't imagine. You would have laughed at an officer who leveled this charge, right?
No. I wouldn't have laughed. I'm saying the child.
No. I meant the
13-year.
In Indy, if one of your fellow officers charged a 13-year-old in this circumstance, you would laugh at that officer.
Yes, probably.
Okay.
We would ask them why they would even waste their time.
Okay.
Let the school deal with it.
So if you'd been called into this scene as an officer, you would have told the administrators, why'd you call me? I'm out of here. You know, you deal with this.
Well, I would do it diplomatically.
Sure, yeah.
And say, what do you want me to tell the child? I don't think charges would be warranted. Our prosecutor wouldn't prosecute it.
So, well, that's good.
If you want me to speak to the child, I'll do that. But I don't want the child to be afraid of the police at the same time.
Yeah.
Don't use the police to scare people.
Yeah.
Which that's...
This
we've been seeing
so
that
important. People think that, oh, yeah, let's just bring them in. We'll just give up our duties to discipline our own children. We'll just call the police. This is a terrible idea. It's not what they're for.
That's what I got it the other day. Hey, I'm going to call the police on you. And so I get there. It's nothing technically. And I asked the lady, I said, why did you call me? She said, well, I want you to scare him.
Oh, no.
I said, that's not my job.
Good for you.
But
I'm really glad to hear your call tonight, Renee.
Thanks.
Yeah.
You asked if we had something else. And this is what it's kind of getting down to around with the children. I had a lady, it's been a few years now, and bless her heart, I can't hold it against her because of how the kids are ingrained with, you touch me, I'm going to call the police, you're going to be arrested for child abuse. And a lot of these people are believing it. And a lady actually brought her 8-year-old daughter to the police station. And she said, I need you to talk to her. I need you to arrest her. Do something because she's being disrespectful and out of control. 7 years old.
Ridiculous.
Man, I have a 7-year-old, and I can't even imagine that happening.
I was just in awe. So I talked to both of them, and then I said, can I talk to your little girl alone? And the mom said, sure. So I asked the little girl, you know, what's wrong, what's going on, and we got it settled, and I haven't heard from them since.
Renee, thanks for calling tonight. I
thanks
appreciate
for being everybody's
you.
Surrogate mom over there in Indy, Renee.
Hey, I appreciate the story. I appreciate your experience, and thank you, Renee, for the call. Our toll-free number tonight, if you want to join us here, is 855-450-FREE. You hear story after story about this where parents will call the police wanting the police to do their parenting for them, and then unfortunately in some circumstances they don't end up with a sensible officer like Renee. Sometimes the cops will show up and then arrest their kids and then charge them with things the parents weren't expecting them to do.
Do you remember the story, and it's probably been a year and a half, of a young man, he was older than, you know, 13 or what, I think he was 16, 17, 18, somewhere like that. He had a vehicle, and the father called the police because he was sort of being unruly in a park or something like that. The police ended up killing him.
Oh my
now,
God.
They had he was in a vehicle. So they had sort of the justification in these sorts of things. But, you know, dad's probably thinking a little later, you know what?
Whoops.
Maybe I could have handled this differently.
I remember the one with the Florida case, young male, teenage, had the police called on him by his grandmother because he'd taken her car for a joyride. And they arrested him, charged him. He went into the juvenile justice, so-called justice system. And
never came out, right?
And he never came out alive. He died. He was killed at the hands of his captors in this juvenile prison or camp or whatever it was that he was kept at. And I think it had something to do with ammonia or whatever. They did something awful to him, and it's like suffocated him or right. whatever. But it was just absolutely horrifying. And, you know, the dude would have brought his grandma's car back. I mean, yep. He went out for a joyride.
For every great 25-year veteran like Renee out there that understands how to handle these situations, there's some new guy who doesn't understand. He's just gotten out of school, and he's like, well, looks like deadly force is useful, or whatever yeah. it is that he thinks. Oh, well, whatever they think, bad things can happen.
Jim is in Delaware listening to the radio. Hey, Jim, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, we're taught in school there's three kinds of motivation: fear motivation, reward motivation, and self motivation.
Yeah, that sounds right.
Fear motivation being the worst. You can traumatize the boy going through puberty to kisses a girl to thinking that he committed a crime. And Dan's saying the two women, Elaine and Renee, are more correct. The guy, Dan, saying that you could turn him into a rapist if you don't bring in the police. I think the opposite would happen. You turn him into a rapist, bringing in the police, thinking he committed a crime.
One thing's for sure, you bring in the cops, you're going to encourage that child to hate the police and to fear the police,
right.
No doubt.
Right.
Jim, good call, man.
Anything else? All right.
Yep.
Thanks, brother.
A fear of motivation didn't work for me. Right?
Yep.
When I was a child, I was experimenting with cross-dressing like five-year-old boys do with my sister, right?
Nothing wrong with that.
Sister's clothes. Right. So my dad got wind of it. I didn't even know. He went to her family physician. Family and physician, him devised a plan to scare the shit.
Oh, you can't say that on the radio. We have to hit the dump button. Sorry about that.
I really wish I knew what he was talking about.
He was going to say something about how there was a plan to scare the S out of him for doing cross-dressing, playing games with
at five.
Sister.
Yeah. Dress up.
Age five. And he was, where he was going with that, I wish I could have found out. Maybe he still cross dresses. And if he does, that's totally fine.
Yeah, I hesitate to even call cross dressing, like 5 year old behavior, cross dressing. That's not cross dressing. That's dress up, right?
But there are some parents who are very uncomfortable about that, right?
Like, sure.
They don't want their child, their son, to turn out to be gay, you know, because that can be a hard life or whatever.
Yeah, I think that you're probably going, you know, whatever reaction you have that is, you know, trying to bully the kid out of doing it is probably going to result in the opposite of what you're looking for.
Indeed. Violence does have unintended consequences. 855-450-FREE allows you to join us here on the radio. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
Did you know that drinking pure, high-alkaline water is one of the most important factors in maintaining high energy and vibrant health? Most experts agree that the water you drink should be at a pH level of 8 or higher. AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops, available only at AlkaVision.com, combine a unique formula of only the most alkaline minerals. AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops alkalize your water, ridding the body of harmful toxins, and helps you regain health and energy. Alkalizing your water by simply adding 10 drops of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops helps
helps the body rid itself of acidic waste, increases oxygen content, and raises the pH of your body to healthy levels. And bacteria and viruses cannot survive in an alkaline high pH environment. Order your bottle of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops for only $29.95 at AlkaVision.com. That's AlkaVision.com. Or call 269-409-1776. 269-409-1776. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at AlkaVision.com today.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live, and you are invited here to join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. And you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com.
So for my family, we found a solution to Obamacare. It's called Liberty Health Share. It's not an insurance company. It's a health sharing organization. And they, you know, they do the same things that insurance companies, similar things that insurance companies do. They spread out the danger of you having some kind of problem amongst a bunch of people. They don't have the overhead that an insurance company does. You can choose your own doctor. That's important to me. And choose your own hospital. That's important to me, too. And I don't have to be forced into, I believe in our state, like one insurance company is just sort of the one that you get to choose from. And pricing for us, it was about half. It was a little more than half of what we were quoted as far as insurance goes. And it's really been a big savings. So libertyhealthshare.org. If this might be right for you and your family, and you got to check it out. So if you're having to pay your own insurance, this really is a great option. LibertyHealthShare.org, 855-58-LIBERTY. 855-58-LIBERTY, LibertyHealthShare.org.
Now, this may not be the first time Uber has ever had a city be welcoming towards them, but it is the first time I've ever seen a news story about it happening. Our hometown, Mark, where you and I were born, Sarasota, Florida, we're actually on the air there on WSRQ.
This is where the Free Talk Live started as a show.
That's right. Amazingly, has deregulated not just Uber and Lyft, these ride-sharing companies, but also the taxi cab business as well. I got to say, it's the first time I've heard of this.
I drove cab in Sarasota.
That's right. That's right. Were you a diplomat?
No.
Yellow cab.
Yellow cab.
You'll be hearing from Yellow Cab in this particular story from the Sarasota Herald Tribune, because believe it or not, apparently the cab companies are angry, or at least some of them, are angry about being deregulated.
Well, when you have the monopoly on the regulation, that's what regulation is, right?
Well, it's not really a monopoly because there are multiple cab
cartelized
companies.
I guess it cartelizes things.
Right. I mean, this is just total institutionalization, where the cab companies have been regulated for so long. They've been so used to being told what to do that they're angry that they don't have to deal with that anymore, because they know that it keeps competition out. They know that it keeps their position in the marketplace, that regulation is good for their business from their perspective, and they don't like the idea of being subject to competition. I want to get into the story. We're going to do that here, and of course we'll take your calls about whatever's on your mind. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Also, people still want to talk about the kissing thing. Roger is in Georgia, and you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Roger.
Yeah.
Hey, you're on the air.
I said that little young fella is supposed to get...
Roger, do me a favor. Back off your phone like an inch or so. You're a little loud.
Yeah. All right.
That's better.
Yeah, I think that the young fellas should get some punishment, because if he don't get no punishment for this right now, to let him know he did something that is wrong, he's going to keep on doing it.
Nobody is saying that the 13-year-old who kissed a 14-year-old with an unwanted kiss at a school, nobody's saying he shouldn't be punished.
I'm just saying that he shouldn't have the law called on him.
Oh, well, if it's my son and they call the law on him, you know, I got two sons. And I tell him stories like that. If he does that and he get the law calling him, the only thing I'm asking the court, how long you guys going to keep him? And if they say 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 6 months, I'm going to let them keep him. Because
you must love your son.
I love him very much, and they know I love him, but I don't go around no corners. I tell him exactly the straight thing.
Roger, thanks for your call, man. I got to let you go. I can't handle the phone. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number here.
I kind of feel like, this young man was, as far as I'm concerned, he assaulted this girl. But I don't think that when you're talking about a school setting, what I feel like administration did here was lay down on the job. Schools have been handling situations like this for as long as there have been schools and co-ed schools, right? And probably even before that. If the school can't handle that, I think that's an indictment on the school, not on the student. Yeah,
absolutely. So here's the story from the Sarasota Herald Tribune at heraldtribune.com. Instead of regulating new age taxi by cell phone networks, Uber and Lyft, Sarasota City Commissioners decided this week to chuck any regulations whatsoever on all taxi operators. For dozens of drivers, that means no more background checks, no more hack license.
I had to get a background check in order to be able to drive cab.
What is a hack license?
A hack license is a driver's license. You get a license to drive.
And it's called a hack license.
Well, that's what a taxi cab driver is called, a hack.
And no more required $500,000 liability insurance coverage. Given the lack of much of the way of state regulations, rulings like this, or in the direction of a stronger regulation of the app taxis, is occurring at a rapid pace in municipalities around Florida. Sarasota's just surprised deregulation move is being applauded by some Uber fans and by some people making extra money by driving part-time for the company, but not by some taxi drivers and the businesses that employ them. John Nicholas, Yellow Cab's head of operations, said, quote, "Yellow Cab of Sarasota is deeply troubled by the recent turn of events and the deregulation." He says he's particularly concerned about City Hall's elimination of background checks and the end of any rules governing predatory pricing prior to known natural disasters, such as a hurricane or a tropical storm. Nicholas said, quote, "If any driver in Sarasota violates the public trust, it reflects badly on every cab company, including Uber." He used to work for this guy, apparently, Mark. Do you remember him, or is it a new guy?
I don't know. I mean, when you're a taxi cab, I just called up and got a job, right? I was between radio gigs, and
somebody... Did they do a background check on you?
They did do a background check on me.
You were a felon.
Yes. I'm a convicted murderer, right. And they gave me a taxi cab license.
Presumably, they found that out.
I would assume, that's the next county over from where I was convicted. I was released by an order of the Florida Supreme Court, but it didn't erase the conviction because I wasn't willing to take it back and, just go through all the time and money and energy that it would take to take it back.
Trusting anybody who gets behind the wheel to treat customers safely and fairly is not a good idea, says Derek Torizo, owner and operator of his own Sarasota taxi cab, the Sunset Taxi. Torizo said he's spent 5 years driving a cab for a living, and during the last 3 weeks, he's made his taxi available to Uber customers as well, just to bring in some extra fares. He says there are so many loopholes around Uber, it's ridiculous. I could have my friend driving on my app and him being a convicted felon. The only limitation is the phone.
Yeah, well, I can tell you that happened in Sarasota, Florida, and they knew it happened.
Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me if there were a number of convicted felons that were driving cabs. I've known a few taxi cab drivers in my life.
What do we want convicted felons to do in our society? Exactly.
Right.
I mean, do you... There's a lot
apparently
of convicted
dig ditches.
There's a lot of convicted felons, and they, they get out of prison. Presumably, they're safe to release because they release them. What do you want to do with these people? Do you want all of them to just live on welfare? Is that your plan?
So you can share your thoughts here with us. More on Uber and Lyft and all the taxi companies being deregulated. This is the direction I think we want to see things go on this program. So kudos to the Sarasota City Commissioners for getting something right.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
So I found out the other day that at guns80.com, a lot of people don't get the Ghost AR-15 rifle kits because they're afraid that they won't be able to do the machining work required to drill out and make ready the lower. Well, listen, guys, gals, I am not that good of a machinist, I promise you. But I was able to take a drill press with an XY table and knock this out in about 45 minutes, and in all honesty, mine looks really good. Go get yours. Don't be afraid. It's easy. Guns80.com. Go to guns80.com now.
Is negative content or comments on the web affecting your personal or professional reputation? Unfavorable comments, embarrassing pictures, videos, legal documents, and bad tweets can ruin your personal life, your career, or your business. It happens a lot, and it's just not fair. But what can you do? Reputation.com can protect your good name. Get a free consultation now at 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771. Call right now for a free expert reputation analysis. It's easy to squash the unfair attacks with our patented system, and the analysis is absolutely free. Make the best things about you jump out in searches. Protect your personal and professional reputation, your business, and your income. Get your free reputation analysis from Reputation.com right now. Call 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to AlkaVision.com to find out more. That's ALKAVision.com.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233. For the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Got some really surprising news from Sarasota, Florida, which is where, Mark, you and I happen to be from, that they've actually deregulated the taxi business, and the taxi guys are upset about it. Now, if they came in and decided to deregulate the radio industry, I'd be cheering. I think that would be a good thing for the business. It would be a good thing for the industry. It would be a good thing for consumers as well, meaning more choices and options. Now, of course, from a business perspective, more choices in the marketplace means you've got to be on top of your game. That means you've got to be willing to compete. You've got to, you know, cut the fat.
It's frustrating to have competition. You know, nobody particularly likes competition, but it's what makes a free market work best.
Oh, and thank goodness we have innovators and upstarts like Uber and Lyft and Purse. You can go to saveatpurse.com and you can save 20%. That's the average. At Amazon, average in the United States.
This could be the
most
important message of the evening that you hear on Free Talk Live for your life.
So the catch is you got to have Bitcoin, which is, of course, a decentralized currency that is not issued by any government or bank. Bitcoin's amazing stuff. You can learn more about it at Bitcoin.com, and we'll tell you about how to get some a little bit later on. But once you've got Bitcoin, you can go to, well, you can go now even if you don't have Bitcoin. You can go to saveatpurse.com, get signed up there, learn about how it works. It's very simple. And it can save you big time. The most recent purchase I made at Amazon, 40% off. Now, I was willing to wait, and I did have to wait a few days, several days, for this order to get fulfilled. The lower the percentage, the more quickly it's going to get filled. 20%, you might only have to wait a few hours. So it's amazing. You can make this work for you on pretty much everything you buy through Amazon. Just start off at saveatpurse.com.
And you can buy just about everything you need to live life at Amazon. So this is
pretty
a huge deal.
We'll talk more about the what's going on with Uber and Lyft and the taxi cab companies. They've been deregulated in Sarasota, and they are upset. At least the taxi cab companies are upset about it. You can also share your thoughts. Maybe you're a cabbie. Maybe you drive for Uber, wherever you are. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Gene, the Christian anarchist, is on the line in Tennessee. Hello, Gene.
Well, hi there, guys. Ian, specifically, I'm calling kind of to talk to you because I think you've been too hard on Rand Paul. Now, I know that you have a couple of issues that you claim he's not good enough at.
There's several.
But who else has stood up and stood up against the NSA? Who else has
Edward
introduced...
Snowden.
Who else has introduced a bill to legalize hemp? Who else has stood up and made several other things? I can't.
Yeah, there's no doubt he's the best choice among the Republicans.
Trying to remove mandatory minimums, allowing convicted felons to sort of get on with their life better.
Yep. Yeah, there's
That's
no
right.
doubt. I mean, he's the best choice among the Republicans, but he's not a libertarian.
He's a liberty candidate.
Not really.
And he is. Yes, he is. He believes in liberty. Absolutely.
Why doesn't he call himself a libertarian?
See? This is what it comes down to. He just doesn't do things
because,
my way.
Well, he's also not principled.
I want to know why doesn't he call himself a Christian anarchist? I'm not going to vote for him because he doesn't call himself a Christian anarchist.
I didn't say I wasn't going to vote for him. I'm not going to vote for him because I'm a registered Democrat, first and foremost. But secondly, he's not a libertarian. He's not principled. He's not out there promoting the ideas of liberty.
He doesn't claim to be a libertarian, but he does promote the ideas of liberty.
No.
As defined by smaller government, getting them off your back, getting them out of the drug trade, getting them out of your phone records.
I don't think he said he wants to end the war on drugs.
Well, I think you better check the fine print, because I believe he does. He's a doctor, and he understands the difference between drug abuse and criminal activity. And drug abuse is not criminal activity. It is a sickness, just like alcohol abuse. So I think that you're going to find out that Dr. Rand Paul understands the difference. So, and maybe he isn't saying it the way you want him to say it, but there isn't anybody out there that's standing up for your liberty as much as any of those other candidates, including probably the Libertarian Party candidate. Certainly the Libertarian Party candidate is probably more on par with what you want to hear.
Right. If I'm going to give my money and my time to a candidate, it's going to be somebody who is actually putting out the ideas of liberty in a principled manner so people can actually understand and absorb that principle, the principle being that one should not use aggressive force to achieve political or social goals. And Rand Paul does not put that message out there.
Well, I think he does. Now, you're going to say that he wants to use force against somebody, in what manner does he want to use force?
He's not advocating for true principled liberty. I mean, period. He's not talking about principle. Ron Paul did. His father was out there regularly talking about principle.
I think he does. You got, have you listened to any of his speeches lately? When I listen,
no,
to him,
I really don't spend
like,
any time
like
on that.
Ron Paul. Well, obviously you don't, because he sounds exactly like his father, if you will listen to what he's been saying.
Well, apparently he's got a lot of us fooled, because there's a bunch of principled libertarians who want nothing to do with this guy.
Yeah, because they're not paying attention.
I don't believe that at all. I think we're paying close enough attention to know that he has not necessarily even come out against all wars or anything like that.
Well, nobody can come out against all wars. I mean, I can't even come out against all wars. If somebody bombs my my village, I'm going to attack those people, and that's a war. So you can't necessarily say you're against all war, but you can certainly be against any kind of aggressive war. And I don't see that where he's trying to be aggressive towards anyone.
Now,
and
Jim,
I don't see where his philosophy is aggressive towards
anyone.
He doesn't
want to shut down the NSA.
Well, Gene, hold on. Yes, he did.
What do you mean? He talked about changing the NSA into a Fifth Amendment or a Fourth Amendment study group.
Sure, that'll work.
No, he was talking about shutting down that NSA building. That's not good enough for you?
I never heard that. All I saw was that he wanted to stop them from spying on Americans.
No, he wants to shut down the NSA building.
Okay.
That
it sounds like he said, she said. So, you know, you've got your opinion, and I got mine. I've seen plenty of evidence this man is not a principled libertarian. I'll go dig up some of it for you. I don't have it all at the top of my tongue.
So, Gene, I think to some extent this comes down to one of those situations of sort of what people's tolerance is for their principled beliefs. And I guess I want to ask you this question. I'm going to vote for Rand Paul in the Republican primary, and I'm there's not going to be a problem with me doing it. This isn't Ian. This is Mark. And
right.
What I'm going to say is though, what about if Ted Cruz, who's, you know, next to Rand Paul, he's you kind of, you know, stack him up and he's good on some issues and that kind of thing. What if he gets through? Are you going to go and give him a vote?
No, I'll probably vote Libertarian in that case.
Yeah, I probably would too.
Thanks, yeah, Gene. But, I appreciate hearing from you tonight.
I want to say one more thing, Ian. Yeah. I want to say one more thing. I've been calling you for 14 years. And I've seen you
progress.
You've been
on the air 14 years.
Whatever. I've been calling you since, 2005, somewhere in there. I've seen you progress, Ian, through many stages of your life. And I hope I've helped you change your ways a little bit. But, and whether it is or not, I'm not going to, you know, that's not the point. The point is I've seen you change your positions over those years. And I think you're wrong on this position because you are too intolerant of people. And you're being intolerant of Rand Paul. And you need to...
Oh, I could tolerate Rand Paul. I could stand in the same room with him, no problem.
Okay,
can I get him on the show then?
Not interested in that.
Think,
okay, not interested.
All right. I think you're aggressive towards Rand Paul. And you tell other people
aggressive?
Not to be aggressive.
What are you
passive
talking
aggressive.
About? Just because
passive,
I get on the air and
aggressive.
I talk about how, whatever that means. Thanks for the call, Gene. I appreciate it. Look, I don't want to hurt Rand Paul. I don't want to see Rand Paul injured or anything like that. I don't wish anything bad to happen to Rand Paul. But don't try to tell me that this guy's a libertarian. He's not. He specifically will not even call himself a libertarian, whereas his father certainly would. His father referenced voluntarism. His father talked about legalizing heroin on stage at a Republican convention. His father refused to endorse whoever the Republican nominee was going to be. Rand Paul is standing right behind whoever the Republican nominee is going to be. Look, those are just the things I can come up with off the top of my head. If you want, I'll go dig up some information on how Rand Paul's not a libertarian. There's plenty of it on the internet. And, you know, I'm not going to get behind a candidate who's not a pro-principled, pro-liberty person. I got limited time and effort, and it's going to go to a principled guy.
For P150, P150GA, P150OK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100, and things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company, 1-800-809-5580. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away, so you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-809-5580. That's 1-800-809-5580. 1-800-809-5580.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey System. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't pick on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
You can join us here on Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything that happens to be on your mind. You can do that toll-free at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. With you in studio, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
Join us online over at freetalklive.com. And if you would like to counter Gene the Christian Anarchist call with some information about Rand Paul not being a libertarian, you're welcome to call in, since, you know, the Rand Paul fanatics seem to love to call and try to rake me over the coals because I won't get on board their bandwagon with this guy, because I am only willing to spend my time and money, and probably won't really spend much time anyway, whoever the libertarian candidate is. I might spend the time to go out in my front yard and put a sign in it. But, you know, to spend any money, which I did give Ron Paul some money during his 2008 and 2012 campaigns, to spend money on a candidate means I need to agree with pretty much everything that person says. I don't want to go out there and promote someone who's not promoting the principles of liberty. And Rand Paul is not doing those things. Here's a short piece from Policy Mike. This was published very recently at Mike.com.
Before you go on, I just want to make it clear that, you know, on Free Talk Live, the hosts have their opinions, and your opinion is different than mine on this one. I believe that politicians, that Rand Paul's probably a pretty principled libertarian. I believe Judge Napolitano, when he says that he is that Judge Napolitano is a hardcore libertarian, that Ron Paul is a hardcore libertarian, and that Rand Paul is every bit the libertarian that his father is. I believe Judge Napolitano.
So
when
what
he
you're
says
saying
that,
is Rand Paul is a liar, then? Because
I believe that what
he's
Rand Paul
watering
does,
down the message and being dishonest with people in order to get votes. Is that what you're saying?
I believe that if you're going to run a campaign, that you need to speak politician.
And so that, Ron that means Paul, lying, right?
And that Ron Paul didn't speak politician.
You mean lying? Is that what you mean by that?
What I'm saying is you have to massage the message.
So that's
that
a lie.
That has to appeal to the largest amount of people.
Gotcha.
Because the message isn't stated in the way that you like to hear it stated does not make it a lie.
That's basically being dishonest with people, Mark. If you think one way, but you're not honest about how you feel when someone asks you questions about what your beliefs are, that's a lie. 855-450-FREE, and I'm sorry, I'm not going to get behind somebody who's a known liar, if that's the truth. Maybe he's not a liar, and maybe he's just an unprincipled guy, in which case I'm not getting behind him either. But we can go here to Mike, and I'll give you a little bit more about Rand Paul here in a moment. Mike, listening in Indianapolis, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, thanks for taking my call.
Sure.
I'd just like to make a quick comment on the about the student that the police got called on for kissing the girl in the mouth. That was so stupid to call the police like that. Here in Indianapolis, the juvenile court here, the judge over in the juvenile court here, she has ordered the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department, do not bring any child 12 years and under to that juvenile center for any reason unless it's murder. If they've committed a crime, the prosecutor here, Marion County prosecutor, has every right to prosecute the child if they have evidence that there was a crime committed.
Mm-hmm.
But for someone like the incident of the kissing the girl in the school, they cannot waste the police time and they cannot waste the juvenile court system's time for bringing someone to a juvenile center because they kissed a kid or stole a piece of kid, whatever the case is.
Yeah.
They can't do that here. They can't. The school has to deal with it. You know, unless it's a serious crime like murder or something like that. But petty stuff like that here, they can't do that. They have to notify the parent. The prosecutor can still prosecute if there was actual crime committed. But just to call the police on a kid for something as petty as that, that the teacher could have dealt with, wasting taxpayers' money, sending the police there and going through all that. That's ludicrous, and that doesn't happen in Indianapolis. They can't.
Well, hopefully it won't start, because these more ridiculous stories like this young man getting in trouble for kissing, getting criminal charges for kissing a girl during the school, that we're seeing those stories from more and more places. So I'm glad you feel that it can't happen there. And there was a female cop who called from Indy in the first hour who said that she wouldn't have done anything if she'd been called in.
She'd have laughed at any of her coworkers did, too.
I'm not saying that the kid isn't doing something wrong. What I mean is they cannot take the police here, Indianapolis Metropolitan Police, they cannot take the 12-year-old to the juvenile center and have him locked up over something as petty as that. What they have to do is contact the parents.
I see what you're saying, and that seems like a more sensible situation. I'm just saying I hope it doesn't change for you there, because it seems to be getting worse in a lot of places. Thank you, Mike, for calling and sharing your thoughts here.
You.
I mean, who would have thought any of this could have happened a decade ago or two decades ago when we were in school? This never would have been an option.
It's hard to believe.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. We'll come back to talking about taxis here in a little bit, but since Rand Paul was brought up, and, you know, I don't keep a real catalog of what Rand Paul does and doesn't believe. I've seen the stories where I've thought, gosh, that's not a libertarian position, but I don't really, file them away into memory, because ultimately I don't care about what Rand Paul does and says.
I asked Rand Paul at an event about, basically I was trying to ask him a question to sort of appeal to you. Like, what is it? Why is it that hardcore libertarians aren't supporting your campaign when they did support your father's? And he said, I don't know. I don't know why they're not.
How could he not know?
I'm the best on foreign policy, and I'm the best on privacy, and I don't know why they're not.
Right, because he's not principled. He may be the best of all of the candidates.
And
I've given
that.
Him that, yeah. Okay? But that's not good enough for these Rand Paulites who call into the show. They want me to be 100% on board with this guy, pimping him out left and right. I'm not going to do that because he's not promoting principles
and
liberty.
It's almost like they're intolerant and that they won't have room for another position.
I don't get it.
That you're intolerant and you don't have room for another position.
Yeah, you're right. I am intolerant towards statism. That's correct.
I'll take the most pro-liberty guy in each party, right?
Let's talk to Travis in Illinois. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Travis.
Yeah. I was just calling in to talk about Rand Paul. Would you lie in self-defense?
What do you mean?
Ian?
Let's say someone was going to hurt you and they were asking you a question. Would you lie in self-defense?
Sure. I don't think it's wrong to tell a lie in a situation where you're being coerced. That makes sense. But Rand Paul isn't being coerced.
I would say he's being coerced as much as we are.
He chose to run for president.
Well, he's a citizen.
I agree. He chose to run for president.
Yeah.
I agree with you that he does not at all completely espouse to the world the same principles that me and you both have, even Ian.
Mm-hmm.
But I see it as, if you want to call it a lie, yes, it is being untruthful to water down your message to bring in more people. But
which doesn't work, by the way. I'd like to point out the Libertarian Party has tried this for the last two elections. And ultimately, you could point out that Gary Johnson actually did pretty well in the most recent one, but it didn't work with Bob Barr at all. They tried to water down their message with Bob Barr and, bring this former Republican in, and that didn't go anywhere.
You know what I want? I want the most pro-liberty Republican running against the most pro-liberty Democrat running against the most pro-liberty Libertarian.
Mm-hmm. Great.
That's what I'm looking for.
So go ahead and give him your vote. I'm not going to give him any damn money.
Well, you can't give him your vote because you're a registered Democrat.
I won't give him my money, and I'm probably going to end up voting for the lesser of two evils just in self-defense.
That's what happens every time.
So you won't even vote for the Libertarian in the general election?
It depends on the Libertarian that they choose, because it would be a vote in self-defense. Until we have a world where we can either not have electoral politics or have liberty candidates actually in the elections, then I'm going to end up having to vote for the lesser of two candidates. And you, if I know
wasted
somebody
vote syndrome.
Yeah, you could have electoral politics and still not have the stupid voting system that they have in the United States. I mean, the United States Constitution's the oldest governing document in the world. That means that it's old, bad technology. Sorry to say that the making person just pick one candidate tends to make people pick these moderates. And, a moderate pace towards statism, as far as I'm concerned. Having people be able to sort of number their candidates would be a huge step forward in bringing a better person into the office. But, I understand why you pick the lesser of two evils. But I would like to point out, when you're in your state, your state likely, the electoral votes in your state will not be decided by one vote. So therefore, you are free to give your vote to whichever candidate you want, because your vote won't matter. It will count, but it won't matter.
It'll only matter to you, in my opinion. I won't vote for somebody. If there's a principled person in the race, I'm not going to pick the lesser of two evils, because I'd rather feel good about who I voted for and vote for the principled person. So if the Libertarian Party puts forth somebody who's actually worth voting for this time around, then I'll absolutely vote for that person. And they won't win, but who cares? At least I walked away clean.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah, I voted for Gary Johnson last time. Thanks for having me on, guys.
Thanks, Travis. Appreciate it. All right, we got time for you if you want to join us here. In fact, plenty of it on this live Saturday edition. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Whether you want to comment on Rand Paul or deregulating the taxi business, anything goes here on Free Talk Live. Toll-free number 855-450-3733 or Skype in at lrn.fm.
Want gold but also want to stay digital and decentralized on the Bitcoin blockchain? Anthem Vault, providing trusted, world-class vaulting, has your answer with Hayek Gold. digital spendable gold inspired by economist and free market philosopher F.A. Hayek. Each Hayek is worth 1 gram of gold and is available right now at AnthemVault.com. Sign up today at AnthemVault.com with promo code FREEDOM to earn 6 months of free storage and 5% off all margins for life. Hayek Gold at AnthemVault.com. Get yours today.
What's the matter, honey? Can't sleep?
Ugh, it's this heartburn. At night, it's the worst.
Heartburn? Again?
Yeah, I'm done with it. I'm going to kick acid with Rolaids.
Rolaids Advanced goes to work instantly for powerful relief of your worst heartburn, bloating, and gas.
Feeling better?
Much better.
That was fast.
Mm-hmm.
Kick acid and gas with Rolaids Advanced.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie and let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the Sacro Wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the Sacro Wedgie.
This is the Genesis Communications Network, GCN.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com, I'm Ron Rockstra. Authorities say four firefighters have suffered burn injuries while battling a fast-moving wildfire that broke out in Northern California and spread to 400 acres and forced the evacuation of the town of Cobb in Lake County. Meanwhile, fire spokesman Jim Schwarber says the 268-foot-tall General Grant tree, as well as the rest of the giant sequoias in the Grant Grove right now, look like they'll survive the so-called rough fire.
There was fire activity in the corner of Grant Grove, and it was fire activity of a defensive nature where we put in a low-intensity ground fire along a road in order to remove fuels to help secure a line there.
Schwarber says with the persistent hot, dry weather, firefighters are prepared for a long battle. It'll be a packed arena in Dallas come Monday evening. Correspondent Val Dior explains.
Republican presidential frontrunner Donald Trump hosting a rally in Dallas on Monday and announced on Friday that all of the complimentary tickets for the event were gone. An estimated 20,000 tickets were distributed. Trump is currently leading the GOP field in every major poll, which means tickets to his rally are in demand, with some ticket holders putting the golden ticket on eBay and fetching as much as $200. Val Dior reporting.
Trump's event comes 2 days before the second GOP presidential debate Wednesday evening from the Reagan Library in Simi, California. One of the debaters will be Dr. Ben Carson, who says he learned a lot from his mother, a single parent who cleaned houses from early in the morning till late at night and who refused to apply for welfare.
She didn't want to be on welfare. She didn't like the idea of being dependent on other people. And my mother was an interesting person. She refused to be a victim. She always said there's something that you can do.
The debate will be broadcast on CNN and nationally on radio via the Salem Radio Network. More on these stories at townhall.com.
The following is not an actor, but a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
I had numerous credit cards, and I was struggling with paying them off.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360 to talk to a certified counselor.
I had heard about Trinity, so I made the call. They took care of all of my credit cards, and now I am completely debt-free.
Trinity will consolidate your accounts into one easy-to-manage monthly payment, put a stop to late fees and over-limit charges, reduce your interest, and possibly improve your credit score. You'll save thousands.
The people at Trinity are very friendly. They will do whatever you need them to do in order for you to feel better about being in a very difficult place.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-758-5360.
My name is Ann, and I'm debt-free for keeps.
1-800-758-5360.
CVS says investigators have confirmed that the company that manages their photo website was indeed hacked this summer, possibly resulting in the theft of some of CVS customer information.
The nation's second largest drugstore chain's photo website has been shut down since July after the breach was detected. The photo sites of Rite Aid, Costco, and Walmart Canada were also affected. The Rite Aid and Walmart Canada sites remain shut down, while the Costco site has restarted limited operations. Staples Incorporated, the site which manages all of those sites, says it appears that the hackers used malware to capture user information on PNI servers, but it says there's no sign that the hackers accessed user photos or PIN numbers. CVS says it's contacting potentially affected customers. Keith Peters reporting.
Boston Red Sox slugger David Ortiz has become the 27th player in Major League history to hit 500 home runs. It was in the game against Tampa Bay Saturday. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra. With California voters likely to consider legalizing recreational marijuana use next year, state lawmakers have approved a package of legislation that would create the first statewide licensing and operating rules for pot growers and retail weed outlets since the state became the first to legalize medical marijuana back in 1996.
Lawmakers in both houses of the legislature pushed through three Democratic bills late Friday to set up the state's first regulatory framework for the freewheeling medical marijuana industry, sending the proposal to Governor Jerry Brown. The framework seeks to manage medical marijuana from seed to smoke, calling for 17 separate license categories, detailed labeling requirements, and a product tracking system complete with barcodes and shipping manifests. Patrick Foss reporting.
33-year-old Flavia Panetta beat Roberto Vinci to capture the U.S. Women's Open title, and moments later, she retired. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Join us here on Free Talk Live and discuss whatever happens to be on your mind. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
855-450-3733. Over at panampost.com, they have a sort of a point-counterpoint here between James Ostrowski, who says, don't vote for Rand or anyone else, and Nick Hankoff, who says, Paul supports liberty. So who is right on this issue of Rand Paul? Is he a libertarian? Is he worth supporting, etc.? That is one of the things that came up just a moment ago on the program. You're welcome to comment there. Plus, more on the deregulation of Uber, Lyft, and all taxi cab companies in our hometown, Mark, of Sarasota, Florida. It's kind of a surprising headline to come out of there. I've never seen a headline about deregulating Uber and taxi cab companies together, which is pretty
exciting.
When
you say hometown, what do you mean? I'm not even sure what this term means. Where you're born?
Yeah.
I was born in Sarasota, but I didn't grow up there. I grew up in Bradentucky, just north.
Okay. Well, whatever.
You can cue the banjos. Kind of place.
I mean, I don't know the exact definition of it. My home now is Keene, New Hampshire, and has been for almost an entire decade.
Right. I mean, isn't the hometown of Free Talk Live Keene, New Hampshire?
It is now, but so, we didn't start in Keene. We started in Sarasota.
Yeah, I don't know what hometown means.
Well,
just
look it up.
Yeah.
Toll-free number
I have
tonight. Okay, well, look it up again. Do you have it right in front of you?
I don't. No, I didn't.
Right.
I don't have it.
Let's
right
not speculate. Toll free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Keith in Indiana. You're on Free Talk Live, listening to WIBC. Hello, Keith.
Yes. How are you doing?
Good. You're on the air.
I am.
Yep. Go
all
for
right.
It.
Okay. So basically, I want to call in about the last caller. You know, from Illinois. He had said something about, you know, he's going to vote for the lesser of the two evils. Like, I'm tired of the nation always thinking that there's only two evils. There is more than just, you know, two parties. We, as a nation, we need to look at everything that we do have.
Yeah, I agree. I think that it is important to see who all of the candidates are. If they can possibly win the election, then they should be considered for voting. If they're on the ballot in enough states to, in theory, win the election, then they should be under consideration. People should at least give them a moment and look at them and really consider what their viewpoint is and whether or not they could feel good about voting for them.
Right. Yeah, exactly. You know, you have Rand Paul, who is always down at the bottom of the Republican votes right now, just because his name isn't out there, because he did come from the Libertarian Party. Yes.
No, he did not.
He has more libertarian views as a
he does sound more libertarian than the other Republicans. That much is true.
Yes, exactly.
Even though he has apparently described he has apparently described libertarianism as an albatross around his neck, and specifically says that he is not a libertarian.
Yeah.
Keith?
Yeah, but you know, every politician is going to cover their own butt in the end. I'm sorry.
Well, not yeah. Ron Paul. You
know. Well, okay, hold on. So I remember a poll, and I think things have probably changed since then, but it was, I recall there was a poll done, and I don't know what the research center is. This is just coming off the top of my head, is do you consider yourself fiscally conservative and socially liberal? And then you had whatever the results were, and it was something like 26% fewer people agreed with that when it said, are you fiscally conservative and socially liberal like a libertarian? So they included the word libertarian, uh-huh, and the results of the poll changed by like 20%. So I can see if those numbers are still similar, and I don't know the answer. Hmm. If they still are similar to that, I can see why he might not want to call himself a libertarian.
I don't know if Rand Paul would say he was socially liberal. Hey, thank you, Keith, for your call tonight. Certainly some of the things
if you want to win the Republican primary, I don't see why you would say that either.
Right. So, therefore, he's not being honest.
First, you got to win the Republican primary. The fact is, this year, the presidential race is in the Republican primary. The Democrats they are not fielding a
real... It's still early yet. You know, we're not even into 2016.
Who do you think is going to come into the Democratic side?
I have no idea. I don't predict these things.
Right. You don't pay any attention. What you've got on the...
No, even if I paid attention, I wouldn't make predictions. I don't know what's going to happen.
I'm not making a prediction either.
Who knew John McAfee was going to throw into the race and start his own political party?
Is he on the Democratic side?
No.
No. Okay. So
you couldn't have predicted that, though.
On the Democratic side, you have people that are just not going to make it. You have a creepy toucher. You have a woman who has so many scandals that it's crazy. And then you have
there are other
a
Democrats.
Man
you
that
may
is
have,
going to be 6 years older than Reagan.
You
who
might
went,
have a few more candidates.
No, you're not going to have any more candidates on the Democratic side.
It's not
side.
Too late to file. Let's go to Mike listening in Georgia. You're on Free Talk Live.
Yes, sir.
Hey, you're on the air.
I just had a question. You there?
Yeah, right here.
Okay. All right, just a question about everybody paying their own fair share. I might be a little bit illiterate of this. These are things I've heard all my life. The people that own the grocery stores, the gas stations, the motels and hotels and everything, I've always been told that they have a tax-free status for a certain number of years, and then supposedly they're supposed to come out of it and then enter into a tax-paying status. But
it depends on where you live. Sometimes local municipalities will grant property tax exemptions for a number of years. So it's happened with like Walmart, for instance, where Walmart will come in and they'll want to create a new store in a certain town, and they'll tell the town, well, look, we'll come in, but you have to grant us these benefits, and then later they'll start paying taxes. So, yeah, that does happen. It's not everybody.
No, I'm speaking of like the Indians and the Pakistanis and all that own grocery stores and gas stations and restaurants.
That sounds
hotels.
Like a rumor to me. I've never heard of that.
I don't see any particular reason why that would be the case. Is as if it's the classification of business, or certainly not the ethnicity of the person.
No, it's more likely that big mega corporations are going to be able to wield tax-free status because they've got the, you know, the political capital.
But they do have enterprise zones. Some places in some towns, they'll say, look, you don't have any taxes for a certain amount of time if you move a business in here.
Okay.
Yeah, all they wouldn't be able to do that. I'm sorry. I was going to say they wouldn't be able to get away with that, giving one group of people a special benefit. I mean, that would be a clear discrimination lawsuit if they did that.
Speaking specifically of one nationality, but that just seems to be the majority of foreigners that come in that start the businesses or buy the businesses after they're built.
What you're seeing is a factor with immigrants. They tend to be more entrepreneurial than Americans do.
It's harder for them to get jobs sometimes, too.
Yeah, they're more likely to start a business on their own. They're more likely to invest. They're more likely to hire people. That's just, maybe it's just the way they were raised or the fact that they, you know, hated the place where they were being oppressed, and they wanted to come to a place where they could have opportunity. And Americans are just, you know, more likely to be lazy and shiftless.
A lot of times you'll also find that the particular types of businesses are employee intensive. So what you'll have is a family over in Pakistan will give money to one person to come over here, start a business, and then that person can sponsor people from that family to come over and work in that business. So that can be helpful for them in that way, too.
Okay. Have I got time for one more question?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, I heard a headline on another conservative talk show yesterday coming home from work, and it was that Office Depot, Office Max, I can't remember which one it is refusing to print flyers for the organizations that are protesting the, what are the clinics that are going on now that's having the big problem with abortions and all that. The
Planned Parenthood?
Yeah, Planned Parenthood. This particular company, either Office Depot or Office Max, is refusing to print flyers for antis or protesters of Planned Parenthood. Is that legal for them to do?
It should be. You know, it's their business, so they should be able to make that choice. Whether it's legal or not, I don't know. We've seen some really questionable legal decisions recently about people refusing to make cakes for folks and then being forced to do it. And so I don't know
that's what I was referring to. That would be kind of a double standard if it was a private business owner refusing to make a cake, but then again, a big corporation refusing to print flyers for certain.
I think they should be allowed to refuse to print those flyers, but I also, you know, I don't know what the legal status is in whichever state where that might be happening. And I would also caution getting, you know, reliable information from talk radio. Always check the source. I don't know if it's actually true that, you know, what you're saying, that Office Max would refuse those.
Okay, I wasn't questioning the legal terminology.
Yeah, no, I get where your question was coming from.
Not whether or not it was specifically true or not.
Thank you, Mike, for your call tonight. I do appreciate hearing from you. But I would also question the source on that one, too. You know, Office Max does want to make everybody happy, and seems unlikely they would turn it down. It's Free Talk Live.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
For over 5 years, you've been hearing about the Berkey guy, so you may know a few things about him. For example, you are well aware of the superior quality and effectiveness of Berkey water filters and accessories. But did you know the Berkeys have had independent lab tests done to prove just how effective they are? It's true, and he can email you the test results. Just visit GoBerkey.com. You may also know that the Berkey guy has helped tens of thousands of people get better prepared. Now here's something you may not know. GoBerkey.com has amazing specials and deals all the time on a wide variety of survival and preparedness products, most ready to ship same day.
Visit The Berkey Guy at GoBerkey.com and be sure to click the red Products on Sale Now button. You can always call toll-free 877-886-3653. Again, that's 877-886-3653. GoBerkey.com, home of The Berkey Guy.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
As if chlorine in our water weren't bad enough, now they're adding ammonia?
It's true. Some municipalities are now adding ammonia plus chlorine to your water supply. It's a disinfectant called chloramine. But with a trusted Big Berkey water filter, you can keep chloramine out of your water. New NSF EPA certified lab tests show EPA Berkey water filters remove chloramines, pharmaceuticals, BPA, pesticides, bacteria and viruses, all forms of fluoride, and much more. Big Berkey water filters are the original and most trusted on the market, the gold standard in water purification. And our filters last for years at less than 2 cents per gallon. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get your Big Berkey today. Call 1-877-99-BERKEY or click BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. That's 1-877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything that you want here toll-free. It's the live Saturday edition. 855-450-3733. We talked briefly about Bitcoin earlier and how you could save 20% when you pay with Bitcoin on your purchases at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. But maybe you don't have the amazing decentralized currency that has been created by an anonymous Satoshi Nakamoto. No one knows who this guy is. He released it to the world 6 years ago. It's become arguably the world's most valuable currency. And it's an incredible thing. If you don't know enough about Bitcoin, go check out bitcoin.com to learn more about it. But when you're ready to get some Bitcoin, you can do it without paying any transfer fee by using our coupon code over at expresscoin.com. The code is FTL, like Free Talk Live. So don't forget that code. It'll save you on up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency. And they don't just have Bitcoin. They also have Litecoin and Dogecoin. ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. And they are a licensed money services business. You can get your Bitcoin or those other ones with a money order or check. Just start at ExpressCoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. It is expresscoin.com. They've got an app for your smartphone. And don't forget to use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live, to save on up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency. No transfer fee with coupon code FTL at expresscoin.com. Mark, you dug around on this Office Depot claim. Tell me about it.
Yeah, it turns out that Office Depot did apologize for offering and offers to print the anti-abortion flyer. Previously, I guess it was in Schaumburg, Illinois, that they were turned down. And the reason was not only were they calling the flyer calling for prayer, but office they claimed that it had essentially was calling for persecution of people who support abortion rights. And so they've changed their position. And, you know,
well, it sounds to me like somebody at the store level turned this person down and it escalated to management. And then management, you said it was a CEO or somebody high up made a statement about this. So yeah, it sounds like it was, you know, one of those things where the employees did something that the higher ups decided they shouldn't have done.
Yeah, I mean, it does have that sound. I haven't dug any further to find out exactly what transpired, but and likely, you know, nobody wants you to know exactly what transpired because that doesn't help their side of things.
Like there was also another, I think it was Arby's or something like that recently, where some manager there refused to serve a cop. And of course, you know, I totally support companies refusing to serve people for whatever reason that they want to. And refusing to serve a cop, who knows what that cop did to people. I would stand behind that person, but Arby's corporate came out and said, you know, you got to serve the cops.
Wasn't that specifically about the police officer carrying a gun into the store?
Don't know.
And there's an anti-gun policy there. So, I mean, well, all that is doing is applying, I believe, a rule across the board. Didn't matter what the uniform was.
Let's go to your calls and thoughts. We've got James. He's in Florida listening via the TuneIn app. Hello, James.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
What's on your mind?
I just wanted to comment about Rand Paul. I love Ron Paul, you know, and I really glad about what Ron Paul did, but Rand Paul, he came out and he was just trying to be too nicey with the establishment, like endorsing Mitch McConnell and stuff like that. And I
and
know
Mitt Romney.
Yes, of course. And I know a lot of people that support Ron Paul, they don't like Rand Paul. So that's his problem. And his other problem is he's losing support to Bernie Sanders, which is sad because he's a socialist and voted for gun control every chance he got. So, you know, it doesn't really matter to me because I think that Jeb Bush or whoever the Democrats end up running with is going to be in the White House and is going to be controlled by special interests no matter what. It's important to have Rand Paul in the Senate because his seat is up and a Democrat could get that seat. And it's really important to have Rand Paul.
Well, Rand Paul is not running for Senate. Right?
No, he is.
He is. That's right. He's doing a double run, right? Where if he doesn't get the nomination for president, then he'll still be in the Senate race.
I don't think he has a chance to win the White House at 1% right now. I mean, it could change, but
it
doesn't matter because Jeb Bush has the money. And at the end of the day, that's who's going to win. And that's
why Trump's got more money than Jeb, I suspect.
Well, that's why Trump keeps attacking Bush because he knows Jeb is at 5% right now. Why is Trump still attacking Bush? It's because
Trump attacks everybody. He called Carly Fiorina ugly. I think that we have seen the death. I think we've seen the death knell for Donald Trump.
You think
so? At this point, he's just hurtling insults at people. I mean,
isn't he the top candidate?
American women are not going to vote for Donald Trump after he calls this lady who has been extraordinarily successful ugly, and she's not ugly either, by the way. And I'm not going to qualify it by saying for her age or anything like that. You know, she's not an ugly woman. He just calls her ugly. I mean, it's petty. This is not what you want from your chief executive.
Well, Trump's not going to make it. Bush is going to force his way in there somehow, some way. And, you know, that's why we need Rand Paul in the Senate. That's why we need people to oppose the White House, because it's going to be controlled, in my opinion, no matter what, because of the special interest.
James, thanks for your call and your thoughts. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's talk to Scott. He's in Indianapolis. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Scott.
I am. Talk to you again.
Welcome.
You guys kind of stole my thunder, but that's actually a hats off to you for researching it. I was going to explain about that office. Was it Office Depot, I believe it was? You actually checked that out. I was going to say, I saw that link up on the Drudge Report. Unfortunately, I didn't get a chance to read it, but you already filled in most of the details.
What do you think?
I think that it depends. You know, I think that the law that I'm with you, I think people should be allowed to refuse people service, not based on race or anything like that, but on, you know, ideology, things like that, that they can change. Okay, if they're going to force people, as you said, to, you know, make, you know, put a two grooms on top of the cake instead of a bride and a groom, and if they're going to do that, then they should certainly force those to do that. I don't think either should be allowed, but if they're going to force it one way, they have to force it the other.
Well, shouldn't be forcing any business owner to do anything that is against their will. It's their business. Yeah. They should be able to discriminate against somebody based on their gender, their race, or their hair color, the way they smell, whatever it is that they want to discriminate against. And I should also be free to choose not to do business with bigots and racists and people who... So I want to know. I want to know when somebody tells somebody... get out of here because I don't like the way you look or whatever.
Right,
I
that's one
know
really
that.
Important right. thing to point out with this gay marriage thing with forcing cake makers to make cakes for people they don't want to. All you've done is force the races or the bigotry underground. You're now making really. I mean, what's the point of that? Because now don't want to make a cake for you, hold on. When I don't want to make a cake for you, all I say is I'm booked up. Sorry.
Okay.
Scott, anything else you want to share? Thanks for the call. Appreciate it. 855-450-FREE. Tony is in New Jersey. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Tony.
Hi, how you doing?
Welcome.
I got three concepts. I'll try to put these in the proper structure. First of all, you have to be 35 years old to be a president. You have to be 25 years old to be a senator. By that time, no ideals are after 35 years old. The old blood group is an anti-youth government group. All judges are lawyers. Half of Congress and the Senate are lawyers. Everybody running for the president has been either a lawyer or has a legal degree. So what we have is no will of the people. As long as you have an electoral college, you really don't have a body of people that have any say. So it's a rigged system.
Tony, stand by. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free line. You can join us on Free Talk Live.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
Do you have difficulty taking supplements? Are you searching for a high-quality, complete nutritional drink that your whole family will love? NutriMedical's Life Support has arrived. All of your daily nutritional requirements in one quick, delicious drink. Dr. Bill Deagle's Life Support is a proprietary blend of vegan protein, activated vitamins, essential minerals, amino acids, probiotics, green tea, digestive enzymes, anti-inflammatories, cancer prevention, detoxification, and much more. Your body will high-five you for this one. Life Support is the best complete nutrition meal replacement on the market. Whether you are an elite athlete, have post-operative challenges, chronic illness, elderly, or a family that just wants a quick, delicious drink, try Dr. Bill Deagle's Life Support for optimized nutrition in one great-tasting smoothie. Just add cold water, almond milk, fruit, or anything else you like. NutriMedical's Life Support. Try our great-tasting chocolate or vanilla today. Call 888-212-8871 or visit us online at NutriMedical.com. NutriMedical.com for the whole family.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Quantitative easing, unemployment at depression levels, Europe financial system falling apart, China getting out of U.S. treasuries. At the end of 2008, the time of TARP, the national debt was at $11 trillion, gold trading around $850 per ounce. Close to 2012, the national debt exceeded $16.4 trillion, gold doubled to $1,600 per ounce. The $20 trillion threshold for the national debt is inevitable. Politicians in Washington have a ferocious appetite for spending and stimulus. What's worse, a printing press to finance. 100 years ago, we had a gold standard to limit this madness, but now you have to adopt your own gold standard. Don't be fooled with paper promises. Get Midas Resources 10 Reasons to Buy Gold free by calling 800-686-2237. Understanding the gold and silver market may be the only insurance you could have to avoiding the next economic crisis. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order your free copy. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live, live Saturday edition, continuing here, and you can join us on the radio waves, 855-450-FREE, that's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, Ian here.
And Mark.
Bitcoinist.net, the prime online destination for information about Bitcoin and the digital currency industry. You want to learn about Bitcoin? They've got some good stuff over there. They've got a solid beginner's guide. Plus, if you're really into Bitcoin, you can get all kinds of great news like Bitcoin and digital industry news and fintech and blockchain tech news as well. And they've got sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics. You can go there. Their Bitcoinist platform serves the needs of everyone looking to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies, from beginners to experts. So whatever your level of expertise, go to Bitcoinist.net. That's Bitcoin, I-S-T, Bitcoinist.net. As we go back to your phone calls and thoughts, Tony is listening in New Jersey. Tony, you were saying, and I think rightfully so, you were observing that so many politicians are lawyers and that there's corruption all over the place. These attorneys are basically just passing new laws so they can send themselves business. I mean, it's this lawyer industrial complex, as Mark has described it on the air a number of times, and you're frustrated with it. You call it a rigged system.
Yes, because if you look at every president, right from Kennedy, they're all law degree people. Hillary's got a law degree. Trump's got a law degree. Everybody's connected to the legal machinery. There's a Latin phrase. It says, I'll pronounce it, hopefully. Stat pro rationa, the will of the people. The Statue of Liberty has a symbol in her hand. It's a torch. Most people after 35 would like to take that flame out and put a credit card in it. The American dream has become a capitalistic idea for the American. That's not what the American dream was. The ideal only the young people understood it. It's the flame of freedom, not from money, but to be free, because the whole world has been enslaved since the Romans. I'm talking about white slavery, too. Aristotle, Plato, they all believed in slavery. So it's 2015, and we've got the ruling class is the legal machinery. They do whatever they want. They find all the loopholes. And why aren't there young people running for president? They got that part covered, too. You got to be 35 years old. By that time, you join the old blood group, because that's how you get ahead. They let you get in at 25 to be a senator. By that time, you pay your dues and you realize it's a lost game.
Yeah, I am not real excited about the idea of heading down to, I don't know, Cabo San Lucas on spring break and grabbing the nearest drunk college student and throwing him in the Oval Office. I don't think that that's particularly a solution to the problem. I do agree with you that we have a lawyer industrial complex, and that the government has become sort of a for-profit organization that exploits its monopoly over over people at the expense of people's liberty. I don't think the youth of the person in the office is going to make a difference, though.
Tony, thanks for your call, man. Appreciate it. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype, and I don't think we've had any Skype calls tonight. You can join us on Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm.
What other show lets you do that?
There's got to be some other show. I just don't know what it is.
Yeah.
So 855-450-FREE. Let's see here. We were talking about the taxi cab deregulation, the taxi cab drivers and the bus people over in Sarasota County, Florida, are angry. They are upset that their business is being deregulated. Now, to me, that would make me elated if I found out that the FCC were shutting down, because the proposal here that has been now voted on by the Sarasota County Commissioners, they decided to chuck, this is according to the Herald Tribune, to chuck any regulations whatsoever on all taxi operators. They're wiping it out.
Well, I don't know what specifically how many taxi companies there are in Sarasota, Florida.
There are at least a handful.
But usually what you're going to hear from is the big guys, right?
Yep.
And the big guys in Indian industry, well, they're the ones that wrote the regulations in the first place. They use the regulations to keep out people that they consider unqualified. And by unqualified, they mean new competition. And so, yeah, of course they're unhappy. And anybody who jumped through the hoops isn't going to be like, oh, yeah, you know what we need? We need more people with cars competing with me to drive down prices and drive up customer service. That's not what any industry wants.
It's a shame. They ought to be ashamed of themselves.
No industry wants to see deregulation unless they got to write the regulations in the first place. So if you're talking about complete elimination of regulations, they're not going to want that because—
But Mark, an unregulated industry, I disagree with your statement. An unregulated industry generally would not want regulations because they understand it would increase costs on their doing business. Now, maybe some of them would see that that would somehow benefit them because it would keep new upstarts and innovators out in the future. But I mean, you see it with the internet business, for instance. A lot of people in the internet world, they push back against the idea of regulating the internet. To them, the freedom to be able to do business the way they want to is far more important than the idea of the potential of restricting competition in the future. Good for them.
A lot of businesses, Amazon, for instance, stood against online sales tax for a very long time because it benefited them against bricks and mortar stores. But at some point, they decided, you know what? Let's just go ahead and advocate for whatever system they thought was fair. And then they began going for the regulation. At some point or another, they realized if they can write the regulation themselves, then they'll be in better shape. This is how the cigarette companies did it basically in the early 70s when they did away with broadcast advertising for cigarettes. They all just sort of agreed, you know what, it'd be a lot cheaper for us if we didn't have to advertise on the TV and the radio.
So the big scare factor that the cabbies are dragging out here is there could be felons driving people around. And of course, as you pointed out, Mark, you are a felon, and you drove a cab in this exact town, Sarasota, Florida, the same company that is complaining about that there would be felons driving.
No, not the same company.
I thought you said Yellow Cab.
I did drive for Yellow Cab.
This is Yellow Cab.
Are you sure? Because I thought it was the Sunset Cab guy that was talking about convicted felons.
Okay. You know what? You might be right, but they're also interviewing the Yellow Cab guy, and he's against the deregulation as well.
I'm sure he is, but he doesn't mention that.
Charlie Kennedy, Manatee,
probably knows the business better.
School board member who became a part-time Uber driver in January disputes the worries about background checks. He said Uber required extensive paperwork from him and then made him wait for a background check. He said, quote, "The app would not work for me until I got a note from Uber following the background check saying you can use the app now." He said, and he added that the Uber customer also sees a photo of their driver and their car before they arrive, providing assurance that the person who is supposed to be picking them up is indeed the right person. Kennedy said working as an Uber driver has been good to him. He said, "You're not going to make a living, but it's great part-time." He said,
He
said, "The best week I had, I made $630. I was probably available for 70 or 80 hours." You're welcome to share your thoughts here. Let's go to the phones to the fun. Susie in Indiana, you're on Free Talk Live listening to WIBC. Hey, Susie.
Hi, how's it going?
Good. You're on the air.
Well, thank you. Sure. Yeah, I'm calling about the caller that said that people were coming in our country and working tax-free. and having businesses, not paying taxes. I know that to be a fact. A guy that I worked with, he was from India, and he didn't pay taxes for 10 years.
Well, I don't pay taxes either. I was born in Florida.
Well,
shouldn't we be celebrating the people who don't pay taxes?
Should we celebrate?
Yeah.
I think it should be fair.
I agree with you on that.
A friend of mine worked for a man from India at a marathon station. She was a bookkeeper, and she was putting all the taxes together, all the
You sound like vicious rumors to me.
People pay. No.
Yeah, they do.
She's not a liar.
Susie, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. 855-450-FREE. If somebody's not paying taxes, they are a hero. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. blockitpocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows, pause and rewind live TV, even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Do you owe the IRS money? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. There is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call now for your free and confidential analysis. 800-481-3147. Again, that's 800-481-3147. 800-481-3147.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. We got time for you if you are on the phones right now at 855-450-FREE. If you don't get in tonight, no worries. We do the show 7 nights a week live. So you can always join us for another episode in 21 hours or so. So you can join us online, of course, over at freetalklive.com, maybe on your local radio station. And if your local station doesn't carry Free Talk Live all 7 nights a week, but maybe you get one or two, you can call, talk to the program director, tell him or her thank you for airing Free Talk Live, and ask for some more. Because we got 21 hours a week that we do. And, of course, you can always grab it online anytime you want over at freetalklive.com as we go. By the way, it's Ian with you here.
And Mark.
And, Mark, you've got a quick insert here on taxing immigrants?
Yeah, they're from Houston, the Houston Chronicle. Apparently, this was that rumor was going around that certain immigrants don't have to pay taxes sometime. And so several sites have looked it up and proven it as false, including Snopes and the Houston Chronicle here.
Yeah, this sounds like an email forward.
Right. Resident aliens are subject to the same tax laws as U.S. citizens. They pay income, Social Security, Medicare, and all other taxes citizens pay. And if they start a business, those businesses are taxed like any other business.
Yeah, the government's not going to leave somebody alone
right.
with
you know,
taxes.
Let's take a persecuted underclass and make sure that they pay fewer taxes. No, governments go after the weakest.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. But that said, if somebody is successfully able to avoid paying taxes, I still think they're a hero. Let's continue here. Your calls and thoughts. David, listening in Lynchburg, Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, David.
Hey, how are you doing tonight?
Hey, go ahead.
I'm with you. I celebrate people who don't pay taxes, but as far as I know, I owe the IRS zero money. I'm an entrepreneur, and I love the idea of Uber because not only is it a capitalist solution, but the model is great, but the people who take the risk of taking their own vehicle and picking up strangers, you know, that's what we do as entrepreneurs. We invest in this case, your car, your driver's license, mm-hmm. your good record, and you go out and you try to get a return on that investment. And these are easy, relatively easy rules to follow if you're willing to take the risk. The problem with all of the people who poo-poo capitalism as some kind of an evil scheme is they would replace it with something else that would be run by government, and then it depends on who's running it. And whether or not you can follow those rules is up to their sort of subjective idea. And then that's when things fall off, when the wheels come off. You know, when you see an opportunity, find the need and fill it, that's Uber. That is great. That's what entrepreneurs do, and I really get concerned for our country when we start letting people say capitalism is bad.
Well, okay, so I guess my only concern with what you have to say here is I largely agree with you. The term capitalism was a term that was created by socialists as a pejorative for...
Wasn't it Karl Marx?
Yeah, well, it was Karl Marx was among the first.
Okay.
As a pejorative for the system that was existing at the time. The system that was existing at the time was by no means a free market, certainly freer than in some... in the U.S., it was freer than it is today. But... you know, the term capitalism draws up a lot of negative attitudes for people, whereas the free market, you can sort of, you know, by etymologically point to this is about freedom. Capitalism doesn't necessarily mean that in what you say. So I would encourage you to switch over your terminology from – I can hear what you're saying. You're saying the capitalism and free market, these are synonyms to you, whereas I don't think that they are to many people.
Well, not only – caveat to that would be that the one thing that human beings can be trusted to do, and probably the only thing that they can be trusted to do, is to pursue their own best interest.
Yeah, that's
and
true.
And of all the ideologies that have come out over the centuries and eons, capitalism or free market principles
are sort of the law of the jungle. You don't get to repeal them. And even if you're dealing with a Marxist or a communist or a socialist, eventually, on a fundamental level, you're dealing with a capitalist because they're going to use those rules to pursue their own best interest. And if you give them power over you, then they're going to pursue their best interest, and it will be definitely to the negative for you. In a free market, everyone pursues their best interest. It's all sort of monetized, and then it becomes about trade rather than control.
David, good call, man. I appreciate you. Thanks for the call tonight. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. We got Andrew. He is listening in Mobile to WAVH-FM. Hey, Andrew. Uh-oh, he hung up just as we picked up the phone. All right, how about we go to Tennessee, where Will Coley is on the line from Muslims for Liberty. Hey, Will.
Hey, what's up, guys?
What's on your mind?
Well, I figured I'd give a little personal viewpoint into the discussion about taxes and immigration.
Sure.
My wife came over as a student originally from Africa, and she paid both in-state and out-of-state tuition fees each semester that she went to school. So she gave more than the average student.
Wow.
Now that she is a resident alien, she's had her green card for about 5 years, six years now. We both pay taxes. We both file income taxes as a married couple. She pays as much in taxes as I have to pay on my own income. And to add to that, we've spent to date about $6,000 on getting her residency after we got married, in legal fees and in fees that you pay to file the paperwork that you pay directly to the government. $1,500 every time you file, as a matter of fact, and we had to file three times, once because of a mistake the government made in the filing, so we had to start from scratch and pay everything all over again. Another time because one of our sponsors fell through, and then the third time when we finally were able to get her green card. So we're out about $6,000, and we probably have about $2,000 more to spend before we get her full citizenship, which will include a drive from my home in Tennessee to Texas.
Wow.
For an interview. That we'll have to go there and be in Texas at like 8 o'clock one morning to go and do a 30-minute interview and then come back to Tennessee.
It's ridiculous.
God.
Yeah. So
at some point or another, you just got to wonder to yourself, why is it so difficult for somebody to come here and make a better life for themselves? I mean, people that are going to pay taxes, I mean, which is what everybody seems to want them to do, and live a good life, but they make it so difficult.
Well, I mean, it's extremely expensive. I'm an American citizen. I literally had to pay my government thousands of dollars for permission to marry my wife.
Yeah.
And for it to be seen as legal and them not to force her to leave the country and take her away from myself and my children. And anybody who sits and talks about
how your anchor babies.
Right. Yeah. Anybody who sits and talks about how people should follow the law and follow the system have no idea what the law and the system itself entails.
I believe that.
They like to think that they do, and they like to think that they know, but they don't know. A lot of what we know is mythology, and it was changed in the mid-80s, and people still think that those old laws that were in the mid-80s are what's in effect today. Getting married to an American citizen does not get you a green card anymore. It requires a lot of effort, a lot of legal fees, and a lot of money to get married to an American citizen. It's not like it's not easy like it used to be. They changed all of that and have done everything they can to make it as difficult as possible for someone who's not extremely wealthy in the U.S.
Yep.
to marry someone from overseas, even if they have a college degree, even if they're massively qualified. It's like they want you to have to beg the government for a natural right to choose your own spouse.
Yeah. So much for sending the unwashed masses over here yearning to breathe free. If you can't afford it, you're screwed. And even if you can't afford it, you might be screwed.
Yeah, I think it's interesting that essentially if you're an American that falls in love for whatever reason with somebody who wasn't born in this particular piece of dirt, that it's going to cost you thousands of dollars to have your loved one stay here in the United States with you.
When my second child was 3 months old, my wife was still breastfeeding. I got a letter from the United States government that basically said, your money or your wife. And that – That, I mean, that's why I'm an anarchist today. I, honest to God, that was the point where my mind, my viewpoint on government completely changed, was when the sent me a letter. They didn't even tell me how much of my money that they wanted. They just told me I had two choices. Give them more money or they would deport my wife. They would kidnap my wife with guns, take her away from my children, and send her to Africa and bar her from the country for 10 years if I didn't pay an extortion fee. And that was the point where I became an anarchist.
Is that does your wife work? Or is she a stay-at-home mom?
Well, she was working until she had a recent baby. She worked for a company that does all the shipping and receiving for Denso. It's a big, huge factory that's basically a cornerstone.
I just want to know whether, because I mean, at this point, they can't even claim she's taking a job. I mean, she's just staying at home.
She's a stay-at-home mom at the moment. Yeah.
Will Cauley from Muslims for Liberty, Muslims4Liberty.org. Thanks, Will, for the call tonight. We'll be back tomorrow for the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. Meantime, you can find us online at freetalklive.com. Have a great weekend.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Be sure to visit GCNlive.com today.
Public service message from Paralyzed.
News this hour from townhall.com. I'm Ron Rock. Going out on top, Italy's Flavia Panetta wins the U.S. Women's Open crown, defeating...